Hello, my beautiful, wonderful friends. Before we start this episode of TDW versus Hades, part one of probably many, I just wanted to do a little preamble saying that the quality of the stream and the recording you're going to be seeing is what my laptop was catching when I was actually streaming it. Now, as you notice, the video and audio on my webcam were completely out of sync, and that's probably what I get for using an i5 laptop that is probably not meant for streaming this kind of content. However, the game content of Hades itself is actually pretty solid. I'm surprised how well that works, and the audio also seems to work pretty well. So what you're getting is a pretty alright audio transcript, even though the microphone and the sound card I'm using are iffy at best. So please bear with me on that, but besides that, I feel that the stream does capture the idea of what I want to do with my game streams pretty well. So I'm going to wish you a good time with this, and I hope you're going to enjoy watching me play Hades. Here we go. Hello, everybody. Welcome to the very first experimental, yes, very experimental stream of Streamwalking right here from the living room. And I'm here with my buddy Noodles. I'm going to put him right at the front because obviously he is the looks of this operation. There you go. And I'm just here to lift heavy things. Now, let's see. What do we got here? We have multiple people coming in. Hello, Silent Dreamer is awake. Nice to have you here. It's so good to see everyone joining us. I first want to do a little check if you guys are actually getting sound and images. So how is it working out for you guys? Give me a heads up, because today's stream is all about figuring out how this works. Are you hearing this? Is this working? Give me some feedback here in the chat. It is good now. Oh, that's good. Okay, so what? It wasn't good? Did it start out glitchy or something like that, or what happened? Let's see. Also, Noodles, you're really, really hogging the spotlight here. I mean, obviously, that makes sense. You go and sit here. Okay, perfect. Okay, well, that's very nice. That is very nice. And loud and clear, Captain. Ah, that's good. Well, as you can see, I got the microphone really close up to me here because I'm going to be sitting like this, and I hope you guys will still be able to understand what I'm saying when I'm playing, because today I'm going to be playing my Switch. And we get to, just the soundless thing before the intro. Ah, okay, perfect. Awesome. Well, today, ladies and gentlemen, is going to be a bit of a historical day. And that is because I will be playing Hades on stream. And for me, that is, it is incredibly cool because I love this game. It has quickly become one of my favorite games of the last couple of years. And it's also experimental because, like I said, I'm recording and streaming on my laptop now. It's an old i5 laptop, which is not necessarily usable for video. So I'm kind of curious to see how well the quality will work. What you're looking at right now, there's a lot of technical stuff I'm going to be explaining in this one because this is a test session. We're just going to see. This is a Logitech webcam right here that you're looking at right now. And my video capture, I'm going to be switching screens in a bit, is going to be an Atomos Connect, which is apparently a pretty good capture card. So yeah, let's see what happens and let's switch the screens. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. And I feel, judging on this, oh my god, it is actually working. Okay, this might not sound like a big deal to you guys, but I've spent the entire afternoon today fucking around. Like, I was writing stuff for a story, which actually worked really well. But I spent about 2 hours, let me switch back. I spent 2 hours setting up this capture card, and it was giving me all the bullshit that you could imagine. Like dropping out, you know, not being recognized properly by OBS, etc., etc. And now I connected it in a different way, and now it works. So that makes me incredibly happy. I hope the delay and lag on my voice and on the visual is not too crazy. I mean, what I'm seeing right now... Sally! Yeah, okay. Sally, that's a yellow card for you. Unfortunately, I don't have the animation prepared here right now. But that is... I did not spend the afternoon fucking. I spent the afternoon working on this. And also, hello, Celeborn. It's so nice that you're watching from the couch. Hi there, my friend. And I walked into that. I walked into that completely.
You're an idiot!
I know, I'm a complete idiot. There we go. It's like, I deserve that. I'm just kind of trying to find a place where I can put little noodles so that he also is a part of the shenanigans. I mean, he could also just menacingly look at you like this all the time, continuously.
It's like, I can see you. Hear my bell!
Okay. Anyway, I'm going to put him right here. Yes, Doodles, you could also look at the screen because don't eat the microphone. Don't. He's going to be joining me when playing Hades. So, we've had enough talk. Let's do the first real test, and that is start the game. I need to turn off my amp. Give me a second. Because otherwise it's going to echo over my headphones and into the microphone. Now, I see that the screen seems to be booting up pretty well. I'm comfy. I'm confident. Well, pull up thine pants. Oh, come on. It's not that bad. Actually, it's funny that you say that, Gala, because the reason why this is happening is because I've been losing a lot of weight. And I actually had to... I actually had to pinch some extra holes in my belt. So, I was like, oh... Yeah, I might have lost more weight than I originally anticipated. So, weirdly enough, it's a luxury problem. anyway, Hades. Now, for those of you who might be able to hear it, how is the sound with the game and the voice, by the way? How is it like this? Because this is about the average volume. Can you hear it properly? What's the situation here? Good for now. Okay, good. Yeah, it's like this is about the loudest it's going to be because it starts with relatively normal volume here. Oh, that's good. And you can also hear the voice pretty well. Silent Dreamer is awake, like you can hear both. It's like, yeah, it's all right. Perfect. All right. Well, first things first. Before I even start playing this game, there's an obvious thing I need to throw out there for all of you who might be watching this later on YouTube or are joining us here. Massive spoilers, because I'm not going to start from the beginning. I'm going to be playing this game from the point in my save where I am right now. So I cannot explain the whole story to you, but I will be progressing it. So if you are like, hey, I want to play this game myself and I want to be unspoiled, then this is obviously not the stream for you. However, you knew I was going to be playing this, so I kind of feel that the spoiler is useless, or like this disclaimer is useless. But anyway, I wanted to have said that just to be sure. Now, let's start the game here. And as you can see here in my game, I have spent 45 escape attempts already on this save game. I'm not sure if you guys can read it there. If you have it on big screen, you'll see it. And that means that I tried to play this game for 45 times now, because this is a roguelike. And the idea behind a roguelike game in this case is that you have a gameplay loop you continuously play. And every time you play it, you get stronger. You get new power-ups, you get new things. However, I set out to play this because I want to finish the story. This is not just me playing it with difficulty. That's why God mode is on. I am weak. I'll be the first to admit that I'm weak. But I just want to finish this to finish the story and see how it ends. And honestly, some parts of this game can be relatively unfair. And last time I checked, I was playing video games to chill. So there we go. Let's go. Let's start this game. Pro gamer move. Yeah, well, I don't... Whatever. I'm not a pro gamer. I'm just an idiot that loves the art of it. I'm now at the House of Hades. Now I can just show you guys around a little bit. Here is... The most important part of the game is right here. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Cerberus, the three-headed dog. And as you can see in the controls, you can pet him. And I'm going to do that now.
There's a good boy.
We can literally stop this stream now. You've seen the best part of the game. Did you see him twitch? Did you see that fucking twitch? Like, it's so great. Anyway, yes, he is the bestest boy. Goodest three-headed boy, might I add. I mean, he's great. Okay, so the whole setup of the game is that you start in the House of Hades, because I'm playing Zagreus, the son of Hades. And, well, I can spoil that part of the story. Everyone should know this by now. Zagreus was raised to be the son of Hades and Nyx. However, during the storyline, he finds out that Nyx is not his real mother. Hey, God! It turns out to be that Persephone is Zagreus' mother. And the whole intrigue behind this game is that Zagreus tries to escape hell to find Persephone to figure out what happened. And that is basically the simplified version of the storyline of this game. And obviously, there's all the Olympian gods and a lot of intrigue. And there is a lyre I can play, and it sounds like this.
Just need to keep at it.
It's kind of pretty, isn't it? For those of you who played the game before, when you get this lyre the first time, the sounds you produce from it are literally like, you know, discordant sounds. But if you play enough, if you play it enough times, then it actually starts sounding like chords and it starts sounding like songs. So it's just a little thing they implemented to make it, you know, make it work. What's the Saint Sally? Interesting sound. Yeah, well, I mean, last time I checked, a lyre didn't sound like a guitar, but what are you going to do? Okay. Oh, apparently I got a reward. How nice. What? The son of the god of the dead shall someday suffer various curses inflicted by primordial chaos. Oh, so I'm getting a reward for being cursed. That's...
Master Chaos just likes messing with me.
Yeah, I guess. Also, another pro point why I like this game so much, the voice acting and the music is top quality. Like, Zagreus is a sassy little shit, and I love him for it. Now, let's go outside, let's pick one of our weapons, and let's start our first run. Here we go. So, loading time. Also, we're now going to meet one of our favorite characters in the game, or at least one of my favorites. Back, huh? This what he is called Skelly.
Let me have it already, boyo, no holding back.
He talks like this. He talks like he's from New York, and he wants you to kick his ass. And basically, you grab a weapon, and he is like the training dummy. He likes to be punished. Oh, I can choose my favorite weapon. That is so nice.
For what you truly are.
Malfon is one of my favorite weapons. I'll explain in a bit why. Let's unlock a new aspect. Here we go. Aspect of Demeter. Now, Malfon, because the whole point about this game being a roguelike is one thing, and as you can see, it's isometric, and you fight enemies from this angle. But the thing that makes this game... Skelly is someone I think Gala would enjoy playing with. Yeah, probably. I would not rule that out. He enjoys a lot of pain. There's actually, there was a fan art of Zagreus holding Skelly. There's this fan art of Zagreus holding Skelly, like, in an amorous way. And then Zagreus doing, like, a bit confused. And Skelly is like, you're gonna tear me apart, boyo? You're gonna do it? And then that just got me going. I was like, oh no, that is so terrible. But okay, so it is an action game. It is an action game with RPG elements. And the whole thing about this is what I really like about it is that when you start out, you just have your sword, the sword right here. But you unlock different weapons. And all these weapons, obviously you're playing the same game, but each weapon gives it a different feel. Because obviously when you get a bow, you can't do the same things you could do if you had a sword. You know what I mean? So... what I like about it in this case, like, I got the gloves now, and it looks like this. I'm literally punching him. Like, I'm just kicking people's ass physically, and there's something about melee combat against demons that will never get old. Ah, there you go. He just died. Now we wait.
Hey.
See? There he is again. He just comes back every time. Hey! Now, I'm going to go for a little trinket, because you can collect keepsakes. You start with the tiny sword and possibly end up with the big long pokey stick. Yeah, that is actually a pretty accurate description, not gonna lie. You start out with Zagreus' sword, but you can upgrade your swords. Okay, well, enjoy your dinner, Gala, and good to see you. Good to have you lurking with us anyway. I mean, I'll just keep explaining the game. Here you go. Oh, so yeah, tell us what is for dinner. We at least owe that. So what you see here is the keepsakes collection. Keepsakes are items you collect throughout the game that give you little passive boons. So in this case, for example, I'm gonna pick the one from Athena, because I want... ooh, nacho dish. Yum, yum.
Give nachos! Do it! Nah!
No, you've already had pizza.
Aww.
Yeah, there you go. Don't be sad. Let's see. Hello, Miss Wizard Potato is here. Hello, nice of you to join us. So, with homemade guac. Oh, you are really making this hard on us. Nacho dish with homemade guac. Oof. I mean, I had McDonald's before this, because I had no time. So there you go. You guys go lurking, and then we'll see you guys later. Hello, Drimdos. Good evening. Welcome to the stream of Hades, of me playing Hades, while mostly explaining how the game works first. Anyway, so I was talking, there's keepsakes here, and these are items that you get when you give people certain prizes and awards, because you can give people stuff, then they'll like you more, and then they will give you an item or something in return. And in this case, I'm going to pick Athena's boons, because Athena's boons help you deflecting fireballs from enemies. So that's what I want. That's what I want really, really bad. So I'm going to pick that, and then I'm going to walk out the door here. Here's another interesting thing. This is called the Pact of Punishment. And the Pact of Punishment basically is a way to make the game harder. It's a way to say, you know what, I want more challenge out of the game. But also it is a way to play the game again and unlock new items as you go along. So what I'm doing now is I'm giving everyone 2 extra hearts, which makes it harder for me, obviously. And this one is called Calisthenics Program, which gives enemies 15% extra health. I'm going to do that. And now you can see the heat gauge on the left is full. It's on a full 3. And we're going to start this escape. All right, there goes nothing. So let's see what we got here. Also want to check what the audio is like. Now we're going to get the soundtrack. There we go. Okay. It starts in Tartarus. Now, Tartarus is, if you're familiar with your Greek mythology, the lowest level of hell, and...
Hold fast to your resolve, cousin, and climb on toward the surface. No matter how often your foothold falters, I am here.
Could you understand what she just said? I'm just checking the audio still, because I can also turn it up. Like, is it loud enough for you guys? Just want to be sure about that, of course. I'm going to pick the attack is stronger and can deflect, the first one. Which means that with every attack that I do, I can deflect things back at people. Now, let's see. Can we punch someone? Yeah, we can punch that fucker. Boom.
That's what you get.
Goodbye. That went really quick. That's the whole point of Hades. There's a lot of really quick fighting going on in this, but it will get increasingly worse as you go higher and higher into hell. Oh, you can't hear her. Okay, well then it is really, really soft. Let me see if I can turn up the... Maybe turn down the voice. Yeah, I can do that. Give me a second. I need to go to the mixer right there. Also, I'm strategically trying to move so you guys don't see my pants dropping off. Because now I'm painfully aware of that. Here we go. That's the music. How are the voices? Okay, I turned up the audio a little bit. So let's see how that works out. I mean, I can make easy adjustments, no worries. Here we go. Ah, see? Those guys. Hate those guys. Here we go, that's one.
Who's getting punched?
How's the sound now, by the way?
Some nectar there.
Oh, that's good shit, Drimdos. Red Dead Redemption's great. Okay, so I hope the sound is a bit better now, or at least that you're able to hear the punches and everything. Here we go. Better. Okay, perfect. Now, what you see here, ladies and gentlemen, I've gone through the first room, and now I get the choice to leave the room right here. And as you can see in a little bubble on the door, you can see what the next room is holding. You can kind of get a bit of a preview slash idea of what you're going to be aiming for. In this case, that will be a health upgrade. But a chaos gate opened up. And chaos happens to be my favorite god in the Greek mythology. So we're going to visit chaos. Here we go. Also, the design of chaos. I hope that the stream will do it justice. And yes, I'm breaking all the vases because there might be money in there. It's like a Legend of Zelda kind of thing. Break all the pots! Ah! Anyway, let me talk to Chaos. And please marvel at how amazing that artwork is.
You have traveled recently beyond my senses, son of Hades. I persist here only in the fathomless depths. I know what lies out there, having created it, but I know nothing of what it is like right now. Do not tell me. I prefer to think of all the possibilities.
In case you guys are watching this on a small screen, Chaos is represented as an asexual being with male and female features. There's multiple creatures at the bottom, and they are literally holding Earth between their fingers. And this design, I live for this design. I think this is one of the most amazing characters in the whole game. Like, the artwork in this game is beautiful, but oof, that is beautiful. And this soundscape that you're hearing right now, I want to live in that. You know, that's ambient goodness right there. Also, Noodles, you should look at the screen, buddy. Come on, we're playing a game. Here we go. Now, let's see. The chaos boons are always interesting, and here's why. The chaos boons are, well, basically they're like a double-edged sword. You first have to suffer, and then you get a bonus. So, for example, this one says, for the next couple of encounters, you're gonna get more damage by enemies, but if you survive those, you will be dealing more damage afterwards. And this is the one I tend to pick, because I like the idea of, well, being in a bit more danger first, but then actually being able to deal more danger afterwards. So here we go.
Master Chaos.
Let's see. Money, level up, or protection. Now, I'm thinking I'm gonna go for Athena's protection. There we go. Athena is one of the best girls after all, so she deserves it. Here we go. Hey look, it's numbskulls.
What else?
Fun fact, actually, I searched for that. Numbskull is obviously a very light curse word these days, but apparently it actually is a mythological thing that numbskull comes from. So apparently there's a mythological basis for it, and once I knew that, I was like, that it's even funnier that I'm actually beating up numbskulls in this game. Also, yes, Saint Sally, indeed, always use protection. I'm going to pick Deathless Stand from these boons, and that's because this one gives me extra death defiance. Now here's the thing, death defiance is a concept in Hades. Obviously I'm not playing as a pro gamer, yada yada yada, haha. But death defiance in Hades means that if you die, you have basically a couple of lives. A couple of lives before you die for real, real. And I have no idea what that means. Please explain. I'm a noob. But anyway, death defiance basically means that if I die, I get another shot, and there's always three death defiances that you can unlock by basically unlocking more boons. Yeah, it is an extra life, basically. However, once you die, you obviously will die and will be sent back to the House of Hades. Now, I think I'm gonna go for a life upgrade here, because I have some money to spare. So, let's do some ass kicking. What are we gonna get here? Oh, this is interesting. These guys have armor. See that? See that yellow sheen around them? That means that they're actually armored and that they take more hits, which obviously makes them harder to fight. However, I'm using my favorite weapon and I can yeet right through them, so that's kind of nice. Here we go.
Whee!
Yeet! And your face is stupid and you don't even have a face! Wait, no! No, 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 no. Nice! Here we go. Well, got my life up. And especially now that I've played the game a few more times and I have some boosted stats, then Tartarus is pretty easy. The game will get hard once I'm around Elysium slash the Temple of Styx. Then it will really get hard. The enemies will be getting pretty intense. But, you know, this is mostly a walk in the park. It's like, yeah, dashing through the snow, get the fuck out of my way, I will kick your ass, put you on display. You will be my prize, I put on the wall. I will kick your ass and show the whole world you did fall. Oh, kick some ass, you are gonna die. Where is it? Ah, here we go. I can fish! Oh yeah, there's a fishing point. Because of course it is very logical that in hell you can do fishing. Yay!
Another hellfish.
Here we go, there are so many... Wait, what was this? It is an extra life. Okay, there's so many jokes I want to make, but I have to remind myself that this is an all-ages stream. Oh no. Oh, Kick W, is that the frog guy? Like, is that the... Yeah, okay, I think I've seen that one. No Christmas song until November. I'm so sorry. I'm gonna have to fine you for this. Well, I made it I turned a Christmas song into I'm beating you up song. I mean, give me a suggestion to... Okay, you know what? Give me a suggestion to improvise a famous song with lyrics based on what I'm doing, and I'll see what I can do. So I'm not doing Christmas song. Give me something else. Something that everybody knows, that I might know as well. And then I'll try to improvise the lyrics on the spot regarding beating people up in Hades. See if I can. I'm just curious. Ah! No. Also, I hope the frame rate on your end is not too choppy. I mean, I have no idea what you are seeing compared to what my recording is. My recording seems to be...
A curse of chaos has expired.
Less than 10 frames, but what are you gonna do? November, how about just wait until Christmas with that shit? Yeah, I'm also not a big fan of Christmas songs. It's just that, for some reason, Jingle Bells came up in my head just yet. Oh, here we go. This is interesting. I can make a choice here that is interesting because Daedalus Hammer, that's the thing I just picked up, gives you boons to boost your weapons, basically, or your weapons and your armor, etc. And I like anti-Christmas songs. Heaven is a place on earth. Oh no. I just know that chorus line. I don't even know that song that well. But I'll see if I can come up with something. I'm saving this in my brain now, Saint Sally. I'll see what I can come up with. Okay, so here's the thing. I can choose Breaching Cross, which does 900 plus damage to armor, but I can also do Long Knuckle, which gives my arms more range and 10% plus damage. I think I'm going to go for this one because this will help me in the long run. I mean, look at how far my punches go now. See? That's quite the extension. I don't know if you guys ever played Street Fighter and know what Dalsim was like, but it's like... it's a bit Dalsim-esque in a way, like these incredibly long arms. Here we go. Oh, Living on a Prayer, Highway to Hell. Okay, you know what? Living on a Prayer, that actually might work. Whoa, we're halfway there. Whoa, I will kick your ass. Let's see. Feel my fists, you'll feel them, I swear. Oh, I will kick your ass. Okay, that was one. Let's see, Highway to Hell. No, then it should actually be an inversion of that. So like, I'm gonna climb out of hell. I'm gonna climb my way out of hell. Because, well, that's what Zagreus is literally doing. I wanna get my ass out of hell. Oh yeah, now obviously, Hades himself is sending monsters at me. That's why there's a timer in the top corner right there. Oh, by the way, if you pay attention to the purple balls that are flying around, you see that I'm actually punching them back at them. That's the reflection thing I was talking about. And that's what you want, because there will be levels in which a lot of people are shooting stuff at you, and you want to, well, not be bothered with it. And in a way, I was playing this game with my beloved Silent Dreamers Awake recently, and I was like, it's a bit like Volkerball! You know, suddenly it becomes a game of dodgeball like this, because I'm dodgeballing fireballs in their face. It's like, Volkerball, bitches! Yas! Oh no. Wait. Will you stop? Thank you.
You lived through all that.
Highway to Hell. Must refrain from making ball jokes. No, fair. Balls. Balls are always funny. There will never be a point where balls aren't funny. Okay, so Athena is giving me another boon here. Oh, I like that. Okay, the Blinding Flash says that the ability that can deflect, the one that I have, my punch, it deflects fireballs, right? Also makes your foes exposed, so it's actually extra damage. I'll take it. So then it becomes dodgeball with a grenade, which sounds way more fun on paper than it actually is. Let's see, I think we're having a boss battle. Oh yeah! Listen to this soundtrack, by the way.
This is supposed to be pretty.
Okay, so one of the reasons why I love this game so much is not just the storyline and everything, because that is like the main sell, but this soundtrack was composed by a guy who has done interviews and told about this as well, that he is very much clearly a progressive metal lover, and he wrote the hardest fucking riffs for this game. But the fun thing is that if you listen carefully to the soundtrack, obviously it might not translate that well on stream, but that's why I tell people, please go and play this. Every area has a song that builds, and every room that you're playing, an instrument gets added to the song. So it starts with just the drum beat, and then they add the bass guitar in the next room, and then they add like ambient synthesizers in the next room, and then once you actually reach a boss, then suddenly it's like do 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 do, and then the guitars kick in, and it's like, oh shit, you know. And I love that. I think that kind of composition is, yeah, it gives me life. That's one of the reasons why I love this game so much. Oh, hello, Ares.
Into your very capable hands. So many weapons are so indirect, I think. With Malfon, you were about as close to the destruction as can be.
Was that audible for you guys? Just as an audio cue? Like I said, I'm still figuring it out. So, can you hear what he just said, or is it still a bit soft? Because I can still turn up the sound a bit more if need be. Just checking the chat here real quick. Meanwhile, I'm gonna pick a new boon. Yay, the blade dash! Oh, this is gonna be a good run. Yay! The blade dash does this, by the way. See that red thing? That murders people. That is one of my favorite moves. It's like, I just turned up the all-around sound. Well, I can understand. Okay, that's good. Well, I can actually understand it better now. Okay, I can actually turn up the sound here a little bit as well if need be, because it's relatively easy for me to do so. So let me just do that real quick. Give me 1 second, and I'm not going to show you my butt crack, I promise. Haha, no butt crack. No butts. Here we go. Okay, I turned up the overall volume and I turned up the sound of the game a little bit. Worst case scenario, I can turn it down in the game as well. We can play around with that a little bit. Now, I just beat the boss. I got the blade dash. Pretty good going so far. Let's go to the next room. We're going to be gathering some shade. Well, or darkness in this case. Not just shades, but darkness. Oh my god, my husbando.
I can't stay long, so how about we get this business over with?
I'm just gonna admit this online. I am pretty sure that I am not gay, but I do have a thing for this guy. Thanatos is husbando, definitely. Okay, so the trick here is that I need to beat these guys before he beats them, and if I basically beat more than he does, I get an extra bonus. So there we go. That's the goal of this whole thing. So far, I'm five points ahead, so I feel that my chances are pretty good now.
Come, wretches.
Like I said, I have a good weapon. That helps so much. Wow. No. 9-0, bitch. I think I'm winning.
You die next.
No.
You're all coming with me.
No, they're mostly coming with me, fan. But, you know, I like your little voice lines. I like that you pretend that you're hot shit. I'm the one beating you. Okay, I beat him with 18 to 2. I think I've won.
Hang on to this for me.
Thank you.
See you.
Get some shade. Here we go. Have not seen Thanatos in this game before. Well, now you did. And like I said, he is husbando. I mean, Meg is obviously waifu in this game because holy shit, she's hot. But all I'm saying is Zagreus has good taste. Definitely. Now, what I can do two things. I can go for a level up for one of my boons, or I could go to this room and have a Battle of the Gods. And that's what we're going to be doing now. The Battle of the Gods basically means that I pick one of the two, and then I have to fight a whole bunch of enemies themed based on the other one, because that other one will be disappointed that I didn't pick them. And the dialogue is deliciously salty. So, let me see. Ares, or no, I'm going to pick my girl. I'm going to pick my girl Athena. Hey, wannabe cat, nice to see you. Very nice of you to join us here in this game stream. And I'm gonna pick Athena. I'm probably gonna get a very angry Uncle Ares. So here we go, let's pick Athena.
I trusted I could count on you.
Of course you could count on me, sweetie. Brilliant riposte, I definitely want that. Okay, now we're gonna get angry Ares.
Your course of action here was ill-advised, my kin. For war shall come to you no matter what, as I shall presently reveal.
Oh, he ain't happy. Well, here we go. Let's kick some ass. Ah! Oh, so far, it's not too bad, actually. Okay, so you see those red circles on the floor? Like, not the ones I'm leaving behind, but the big ones? That is basically Lord Ares being a salty little bitch about me not picking him. And this often doesn't last that long. Like, if I beat these guys, it'll probably be fine. Come on. Come. Yeah, there we go. And now he'll probably say something along the lines of, haha, I wasn't really mad with you. I was just testing. Yes, I was just testing you, you know. Here we go.
I think that we are squared away for now. Though, do not test my patience further.
Oh, get over yourself. Now, let's see. What do we have here? Yes, I want the black metal boon. Not just because it sounds awesome, but the black metal boon actually creates this. Look at my blade rift. I'm gonna dash now and look behind my character. Look how big that is. That is a vortex of pure death right there. I love it. Okay, now let's go to the shop, because I'm gonna be needing to buy some stuff here. Ares' face paint is on fleek. I agree with you, Saint Sally, absolutely. Also, this here is Charon. And Charon is very, very eloquent. I mean, hear his voice. Riveting. So much emotion. But I actually do love the voice acting. Because Charon is the one that steers the boat that leads all the mortals to the realm of Hades. And he's actually carrying his oar. You see, he's that's what he's holding, the oar to the boat. And his boat is right... Oh, it should be right there, but it isn't now for some reason. Okay. And basically, Charon has a little shop where you can buy certain things that might be helpful, like health and some extra boons.
Plan to get a hold of you via the boatman worked out flawlessly. Honors the might of the sea, then, why don't you?
To be fair, Poseidon, he is a bit of an arrogant douche, but I love water, so it's a complicated relationship I have with this version of Poseidon. But he has some of the most amazing things that he can bestow upon you. Am I going to do that? Yeah, let's use the special. The special.
Cheers, Uncle.
He now gave me the uppercut, this one, see? And it turned blue, and that means that I now got his special power, and it pushes people away. Poseidon gets a no from me. I mean, in a way, this game is like, is it hot or is it not? You know what I mean? Like, we can just judge the characters, like, hot or not. And Poseidon is like, I don't know, he annoys me, but his boons are awesome. Now, please let this be Meg. Oh no. I hate her.
I've got to admit, you're really frustrating, you know, Red Blood. What is it going to take to make you scream,
Okay, so Alecto is one of the three Fury sisters, and she is basically the annoying bitch. And, like, when I'm fighting Meg or when I'm fighting... Meg is like, I don't want to fight my waifu, and with Tisiphone, I'm a bit like, I don't want to fight you because I feel sad when I see you. But Alecto, I'm like, I'm going to kick your ass. I'm going to kick that smirk off your fucking face.
What, you mean to say Meg never told you? And here I thought you two were close.
Oh, snarky dialogue.
Well, we'll find out. I've got plenty of ideas left I've been meaning to try.
All right, let's start the battle. Ta-da! This soundtrack, holy shit. And as you can see, my trick is to dash around the characters so that they get stuck in the blade vortex, and it takes a lot of damage away from them. And meanwhile, I am projecting fireballs back at their face. So, this battle often turns out to be pretty easy, as you can see. That was it. Because I have the right amount of boons.
That's that then.
I also fought her once using the bow and arrow and not having any good boons whatsoever, and she murdered me. Brutally. So it's all about having the right weapons and having the right skills. Alecto is also a pass for me. I absolutely agree, Saint Sally. You are a lady of culture, and I would expect you to choose better. There we go. At least... Yeah. Let's see, what's this? Black Metal, yay.
Alecto failed.
Oh, Wannabe Cat says hot in a creepy way. No. Still, no, even then I'm like, no. I'm gonna be using the Dionysus boon in this case. Now, let's see what else do we have here. I don't need any of this, really. I'm gonna save some money.
That's enough Tartarus. And check.
Okay, so what I just got, that little blood thing you see on the map there, and what I just picked up, that's Titan's blood. The Titans. And the Titans were obviously the parents of the Olympian gods who they destroyed because the Titans were dicks, yada yada yada. That's how the legend goes. And Titan blood in this game helps you to upgrade your weapons. So you can level up your sword, level up your fists, level up your bow, etc.
Getting warmer.
Okay, we're now in Asphodel, which is probably the most traditional depiction of hell. I mean, look at this. It's lava, it's got all these hands sticking out. Hello, little grabby hands. No. And basically, I would say this is the closest to Christian hell between brackets. However, obviously Christianity stole everything from other religions, so that's not a hot take, that's just the truth. So in that regard, it makes all the sense that Asphodel is the most traditional form of hell for those who were bad and who need to burn, so to speak. Or those that got misjudged by Hades. And who are burning because, well, they were unlucky or whatever. It's a bit gray on who actually ends up in Asphodel, to be fair. Now, let's get some money here. That's kind of neat. That was a very simple battle, by the way. I was expecting a lot more from that. Yeah, let's go for a health up. Sure. I see. Expecting me to choose better. I've heard you yesterday, Saint Sally, and still I believe in you. I believe in you to choose a classy, awesome lady, because that's what you deserve. There you go. I said it on stream, and therefore it's true. And if everyone in the chat could weigh in saying that this is the case, then Sally will find a beautiful, awesome lady. Here we go. Let's see what's happening here. Ah! Oh, skeletons! Oh, the skeletons! Oh, the humanity! Well, ex-humanity in a way, because they're skeletons. Die! Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Oh, I can fish? Did you hear that ding? The ding sound says that you can fish somewhere. Now, let's fish.
Sure, why not?
Fishing in lava. Very realistic. Oh, for fuck's sake. Too early. Here we go. Your first mistake. Who knows? Let's see. Am I going to go for a speed boost of Hermes? Or am I going to go for shopping? Shopping. Speed boost. Shopping. Yeah, I'm gonna go for a speed boost. I don't necessarily need to shop right now. Hermes is, of course, the messenger of the gods, for those of you who are somewhat familiar with Greek mythology. And in this game, he is mostly like the Sonic of the team, continuously making comments saying that everyone is slower than him and gotta go fast. Honestly, I feel that he might be on cocaine. But, you know, everyone has their own problems, and I'm not one to judge. Oh, here we go. There's Hermes. Hello, Hermes. Talk to me.
You know, cuz, all this time that I've been busting souls across the borders of your father's land, it's good to have the chance to help somebody out the other way.
He's got a point. In a realm like that, can you blame him? No, not really. Honestly, he doesn't live in this realm. He lives on Olympus, but he just kind of moves all over the place. So Hermes is... His whole shtick is just being fast. Gotta go fast. I mean, honestly, I would think it would be hilarious if someone would actually patch in Sonic instead of Hermes. That would be that would be perfect. Your special is faster. Okay, after you dash, you become sturdy. Yes, faster special. I like that. Bonk. Yeah, there we go. Now I can bonk people on the head faster. It's kind of cool. Okay. Also, hear this bass guitar. Like, you could already hear that there's some metal coming because the bass is so prominent. And you see the little icon underneath the bubble? Yeah, Hermes is also a pass for a lot of people. Underneath the purple icon is a little skull that indicates that we're gonna have a boss battle. So be prepared. And I think it's going to be the Medusa head. Oh no, it's the Barge of Death! Okay, that's nice. No, wait, that's not nice at all. Okay, so this is basically as you can see, it's a locked-in area where you just gotta beat the enemies. I was anticipating an actual boss battle, but this to me is a bit like, at this point I'm like, oh, it's the Barge of Death. Okay. It's not too bad. Like, the Medusa head boss is a lot worse, actually. But we're gonna be fighting a dragon in a bit. A Hydra! this. Why don't you die? Such a... You are all very rude. I'm just trying to get out of hell. I'm minding my own business, and you start throwing shit at me. Well, yeah, then I'll kill you. It's only cause and effect. I'm completely innocent. Really? Now, let's see. Dionysus.
Hanging out with Ares, are you, Zag? He's quite the chap. I'll give him that. And now, I'll give you this.
Okay, so for those... for those of you who are interested, I'm going to spoil this. A certain lady in the chat here was talking about his slutty calves. I mean, look at this portrait. He is a slutty, slutty man. I mean, he is not just the god of wine. He is the god of getting it. Look at that slutty, slutty little calf. Anyway, let's see what he can give us here. Oh yeah, here we go. Using a fountain restores all life and gives you bonus damage. Fuck yes, I'll take it. Awesome. So next time I bump into a healing fountain, it will heal me all the way up, and I will actually get more attack power the next battle. So that's pretty neat. Here we go. Yeah, those are good legs. I mean, hell, I mean, I would say that my legs are pretty well trained with all the cycling and everything, but I cannot win his leg game, that's for sure. Also, he just talks like he's continuously drunk all the time. Here we go. Nah. Where is... Hello? Hello, I'm here to murder you. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Ha! You were camouflaged, you little shit. Ah! Mini Hydras. Okay. Wow, that wasn't too bad.
So much for them.
Some more darkness.
Where now?
Okay. Guys. Girls. Guys. Everyone. You want to pay attention to what is happening now. I'm going to enter this room and I'm not going to say I'm not going to say anything for a while. I just want you to listen. Because we're going to meet a character that is important to the story, and she is a beautiful singer. And I figured, yeah, you should hear this. And she's not singing?
She's not singing.
What the hell? All this preamble for nothing? Are you kidding?
It's only me.
Why are you not singing?
What happens now, hon? What I mean is, now you got me thinking about Orpheus again. So, what am I supposed to do with that?
Oh, sweetie. Okay, before I click through the rest of this text, this is somewhat of a contextual thing. Eurydice is a character from Greek ancient history. The story of Orpheus and Eurydice is actually kind of tragic. And here's why. Eurydice was sent to hell by accident, and Orpheus made a deal that he was allowed to pick her up from hell to bring her back to life. However, the deal was that Orpheus was not allowed to look, he was allowed to grab her hand but not look at her until they made it to the surface. So it's like that was the only caveat. Like, you're not allowed to look at her in hell. You got to get out first, and then you can look her in the eyes, and then she's yours again. But Orpheus was weak, and he looked her in the eyes while they were trying to leave the underworld. And thus, she was cursed to live in the underworld for the rest of eternity. Well, tree lady in a way, because she represents life. She has a tree on her head. Those are branches. If you zoom in on the screen, you can see it. Those are like little branches here. And I'm not sure if you can see my mouse, but... And basically, she is his muse. Orpheus is a singer and lyre player, and she wrote all the songs that he's singing. So for a while when I met her the first time, she was actually like, I don't want to see Orpheus again. He betrayed me. He's the most horrible person ever. And he was all depressed, and he was actually like, yeah, I know I'm a horrible person because I let her down. And now we're at the point in the story where I actually talked to the both of them, and I was like, you guys love each other. You should be together. Like, you know, I'm a very violent kind of Cupid in this game, in a way. So then you're kind of up to speed. Now, let's go to the text that she's going to be telling me.
Even if you can't be together right now, I hope it feels better knowing how much he cares for you. And I will try to pull some strings, like you said. I can't make promises when my father's concerned, but I'll do everything I can.
Well, what can I tell you? Thanks, Your Royal Majesty. That means a lot. No pressure, though. I've been all right without him all this time, and I will be all right no matter what. If only he could say the same.
Yeah, because that is interesting. Eurydice, what I love about her is in the older story, she was often depicted as a, you know, archetypical damsel in distress, not a very strong, independent lady. And I love that they actually gave her that strong, independent lady vibe here. She is doing quite all right. It's actually Orpheus who is missing her more, who is being depressed about it. Because for a while she was like, well, that's his problem. I don't care about him anyway. And now, obviously, she's kind of starting to realize that she does miss him more than she was willing to let on. So I'm going to get a bonus from her, because that's the whole point. She gives me a bonus which levels up multiple boons. Here we go. Awesome. However, unfortunately, I was hoping I could let you guys hear the song Good Riddance, because that is what she normally sings. However, I covered that song on my YouTube, so if you're interested, you could search for TDW Good Riddance, and then you will find my version of that song. Shameless plug, but it's my stream. I mean, duh. Now, later. Bye, Eurydice. Hope you sing again next time. That would be nice. Okay, now, let's go to the store, and this is the last store before we're going to be fighting the Hydra. Sorry, Karen. And yes, I pronounced it as Karen, just to annoy him.
Potentially doing business.
It's like, I keep making the joke that if Karen was actually a Karen, then it would be like, I wanna speak to the manager. You know, like that kind of situation. A pass for both of them on behalf of Sally. Karen deserves better. No, he deserves better. That's true. I'm just being a dick. Yes, I'm gonna take that.
Kill or be killed.
This boon actually helps me in that when someone attacks me, they get doom inflicted upon them as a response. So that's pretty good to have. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you my good friend Lurney, who is a Hydra!
Da 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 da. Lately, Lurney?
How is the magma temperature, Lurney? Also, this song is doom metal goodness. Like, it's slow and dirgy and all of it. Ah! No. That's a lot of lava. Stop throwing lava around. Play nice. Oh yeah, there's the other head. Okay, so that was three heads. But for those of you who know your Greek mythology, it's probably not gonna stop at three, is it? Okay, here we go. Okay, that's one. There we go, we got eight Hydra heads trying to kick my ass. That's... And as you can see, I've picked the right boons, in that the black metal boon is helping me to kill those heads a lot quicker, because I'm putting those vortexes underneath their heads. I'm basically dashing through people at this point. I'm using my punches to deflect the things they throw at me, but I'm using the black metal blade dashes to hurt them. And that's working really well. As you can see, bye, Lurdy. Was nice knowing you. Dashing through the snow. The floor is lava. Yes, the floor is absolutely lava. That's a very, very apt description right there, Cat. Also, dashing through the... Yeah, well, dashing through your face. I'm gonna fuck you up. There's a bit like that. Now, we just beat him, and now we're gonna head into the second half of the game. Okay, let's restore my health here. What I tend to do is get the chthonic... That's word. Chthonic coin purse. Because it gives me an extra 150 credits. And I'm gonna be needing that money in this place. Because this is the place where I need to start gathering all the bonus materials so I can fight Hades at the end. Because the Hades fight, even with all the good boons, still is hard as balls.
Cheers.
Cheers. Okay, so we're now heading into Elysium. There we go. And Elysium is a lot greener than Asphodel was. Here we go.
The dead must have been pretty good up here.
Now, for those of you who are not that sharp on their mythology, Asphodel is like hell for the regular people, and basically the regular people that have been somewhat neutral. Tartarus is hell for those who have been horrible and naughty. And, well, that's actually a good point, Saint Sally. I love the way this place looks. That's because, let me just stand here for a bit.
If I was permanently dead, maybe I wouldn't mind all this.
Exactly. This is basically the place where the exalted shades go, the good people, the people that were good in their life or, you know, who have benefited others, the heroes. They all live happily ever after in this part of hell, basically. Like, this is the highest level of hell, because the Temple of Styx above this one is not a part of hell. That's actually the administrative chamber where people are being judged. But if you were a good person, you end up here. However, a lot of heroes end up here as well, and those heroes are bored out of their skulls. So, they want to fight you because they're like, oh good, a fight! We've been bored for the last 1,000 years! Gives you such a pain in the balls. So basically that's what I'm doing here. I'm fighting the heroes of forgotten times. But according to Greek mythology, hey, technically I might even be fighting some of the heroes of our times, because their logic is that their afterlife exists outside of time in general. So hell, maybe I'm fighting a fireman that saved a kitty from a tree once. I don't know. Let's see. What? No. No. See, this is already a bit harder because you have to beat them twice. And some of these guys hit like trucks, honestly.
Was that really necessary?
Was that really necessary? Yes, well, it's a good question, Zagreus. I don't know the answer to that. Yes, Daedalus's hammer. You see that hammer above the door there? I hope it's visible on a tinier screen there. That's the one I'm going to pick, because this is an weapon upgrade, basically. I mean, if you're in a nice setting, got some strong people around you all the time in the world, really, there's only one thing coming to my mind about what to do. I feel like I should not get into that on stream. I'm already cursing enough that it's not going to be family friendly, but let's not go into the details around that. let's see here. Okay, so... Also, notice how the music is getting more layers.
No.
Alrighty, here we go.
Look who.
Also, I am noticing, because I played this game more, that indeed the enemies are a bit stronger. They're not necessarily hitting harder, but they have just more HP. Like, I have to put more punches in to actually get them. Here we go.
Fix up these fists.
Your dash upper deals 100% damage in an area. While using your attack or special, you are sturdy. Yes, I'm taking that. That actually helps.
Feels better.
Being sturdy between brackets means that you take less damage from whatever is happening around you, and that is never a bad thing. I'm gonna go for another story-based room. Here we go. Let's say there are a lot of games you can play with people when you are bored. That's true.
Always so unyielding.
Not sure if you guys heard that voice, that muffling voice in the side of my ears here, but that is actually a very important character as well. And we're gonna meet him now. He is called Patrocles. You guys might know Achilles. From, you might know Achilles, I mean, it's like the Achilles heel, etc. And, this is his lover. And he is pretty sad about not having Achilles by his side. Like, he is incredibly sad. And, like I said, I'm a very angry, aggressive Cupid that brought Orpheus and Eurydice together. I'm also trying to get him and his husbando together again.
Say, isn't that the Lethe right nearby? You've been through so much, don't you ever... You could just drink deeply of the River of Forgetfulness and be done with, no?
It has been rather tempting, yes. And I have taken sips from time to time. But I've some memories I'm not quite ready to give up on yet.
Oh, boyo. He gives a few different boons. One of them is actually can be a lifesaver, that's this one. He has a beautiful voice, yes, absolutely. Also, I really like this music. It's just the whole atmosphere. Yeah, it breathes a certain melancholy that I really like. But The first one, as you can see, replenishes all the death defiance. That's actually a really good boon, especially if you've made it this far and you've died multiple times, then this is basically your way to get all your extra lives back. However, I still have all my extra lives because my boons are really strong, so I'm going to be using the attack boon here. For the next 10 encounters, your attack deals an additional 60% damage. Here we go.
Thank you.
And I've already made good friends with him, as you can see. Like, this is the screen you see when you push L, and then you can see what your relationship is to someone. And I can still... Well, I want to give him ambrosia. That's like a very special drink, but I cannot do that yet. It takes a bit longer before I can do that. But basically, as you can see, I've got a pretty good relationship with him. So he already opened up to me about his love for Achilles, who we see right here, and how he misses Achilles so much. And it's just very, it's really tragic, all things considered. I mean, you guys were already talking about Greek tragedies. Well, this game is basically one big Greek tragedy. Okay, am I gonna go for extra money, or am I gonna go for a store? Aw, I'm happy you say that. This is making me realize I should watch more playthroughs. Well, I hope that you'll watch me play this more often, because I love playing this game at night to also unwind, weirdly enough. I know it's... For a lot of people, this might actually be the least relaxing thing ever, but for me, this is a relaxing game. And I like talking about it because I love the lore so much. Because I'm a nerd! Here we go. Wait. No. There we go. Thank you, Lithia. Nice to see you here. And yes, Hades is one of my absolute favorites, so that's why I wanted to stream this for my first ever game stream. I'll probably be streaming more games like this and also old school RPGs in the future, so I would not mind watching this every day. No, that's nice. That's good to know. Here we go. Well, I think that I got everything in this room now, don't I? Yeah, I think so. That's pretty all right. Okay, let me think. Angry uncle, hyperactive nephew. Angry uncle, hyperactive nephew. I'm gonna go for the hyperactive nephew because I already have everything from the angry uncle that I want, and I could use some extra speed. So here we go. Now, for those of you who tuned in later, I am now working with the Blade Dash right now, which is one of my favorite boons to have in this game, and I'm using the Knuckles. And with the Knuckles, I'm basically punching people. It's like, what is your strategy? Punching people. That's what I do, punching people. And it works pretty well, apparently. It's like, look at this mythical video game about mythical dramatic stuff. Punching people! It's not exactly the most gracious way of doing it, but what are you gonna do? Also, holy crap, there's a lot of enemies here all of a sudden. I feel like I'm actually breaking a bit of a sweat. Also, the soundtrack is going bananas on the theremin there, as you can hear.
Time for a boost.
Here we go. Now let's see if I can get a speed boost. What is it? Why does it sound like I'm stuck in a microphone 1990 while you have high-end mics there? I don't know.
It's...
Well, that's probably because of the compression with my voice and the music happening at the same time in a mixer, so that's probably the reason. Is it that bad, though? Because then I have to look into that. Because I bought this mic just for this purpose, so if you're saying it's that bad, then I should definitely check that out. Let's see. You're way more timid while playing this game. That is nice. Well, I'm playing. I'm actively playing, and I'm explaining stuff. When I'm writing a song with you guys, obviously, that's a whole different vibe. Let's see, you move faster. Yeah, that's what I wanted. Speed! Yay! Look at me going, Ree! There we go. It's very nice and calming. Oh, that's nice. But, Lithia, you said, well, it's interesting because Well, this is, just to be fair with you, I'm not using the most expensive microphone here right now. I literally bought this one as a cheap one for this very specific point, and it might sound a bit better if I'm getting it closer. Is it a bit better like this, Lithia? Just knowing what you're up for here. Or is it just a general sound thing that you're getting? And is anyone else of you hearing the same thing? Do you think the microphone sounds weird? Just checking. Tiny bit, but it's very flat sounding, kind of. Yeah, no, then it's probably because of the compression, because I'm literally... For your reference, I am pushing the music and the microphone through the same line, and that's probably not doing it any favors. So yeah, I'm literally doing this on a laptop on my couch, and I'm figuring it out as I go. So there's a pretty big chance that I might be investing in better stuff over time. But first, I just wanted to see if this worked at all. Same as with the frame rate, by the way, because I see that the frame rate of the video is... Well, I have no idea if you guys get 50 frames or not, because I see 50 frames here on my screen, obviously, but I'm expecting that you guys get, like, minus 20 or something. Okay, it is not bad, could be better. I'm happy, well, you know, this is good feedback, because like I said, I'm willing to invest. I'm thinking of investing in a small computer with a few, you know, with some extra equipment here to make things sound and look better. So in that regard, this is just a nice little test. And as long as this works for now and you guys are happy with this as a starting point, then we can just, you know, then we can just keep going. Yeah, it is couch gaming. That's what this is. Awesome. Well, okay, then we're just going to continue and I'm taking the feedback with me. Here we go. Yeah, because this is the butterfly ball. This song, by the way, just sounds like a discount Opeth song. I mean, like, this is prog metal right here, what you're hearing. But I don't mind though, it works for the battle. Here we go. Nice. There we go. It's a good starting point. Yeah, I don't mean to interrupt your chill gaming session at all. No, you're not. You're not. Like I said, I'm open to this kind of feedback because I want to see how I can how I can improve these kind of things. I know that the sound I have upstairs is really good already because obviously that is on a pro sound. That's just the thing. Wait, let me just switch back real quick. The difference is here that I'm literally recording this. This is like a cheap mic through a USB sound card that is... you know, like, not too good. And upstairs, obviously, when you're listening to my other streams, which I'll be doing again on Tuesday, then I'm using a professional mic with a good sound card. Like, we're talking that then basically right now I'm talking through 220 euros worth of equipment, while upstairs I'm talking to you through 2000 euros worth of equipment. And it's a pretty big difference. And yes, there is the unicorn. Wait, let me show you that. This is Charlie. This is Charlie, the band mascot for Dreamwalkers Inc. We have him, her, they on the drum kit on many occasions. And of course, this is Chunk Homino. That's Chunk Homino, our good chunky friend. And of course, Little Noodles is here to watch me play video games and have a good time. But yeah, so basically what you're seeing here now is my very first try on streaming for you guys, streaming a video game for you guys, figuring out how it works. And I'll definitely be working on getting certain things improved or expanded upon, etc., etc. Now, let's see here. We're gonna get Mr. Poseidon.
The elder brother Hades must have tried to poison you against us lot. I can imagine it clear as water, nephew. I'm proud that you've resisted his undoubtedly most twisted words.
Yeah, Poseidon, you are a bit biased on that front as well, so I'm just not going to take that advice from you. Here we go. Looks like Charlie got some skin issues. No, yeah, he's a very flowery character, let's put it that way. Oh, here we go. Unshakable metal. You cannot be stunned and resist some damage from bosses. Ooh, I like that. That's
thanks,
neat.
Thanks, family.
Thanks, fam. I mean, he said thanks, family, but it would have been great if he actually went, thanks, fam. You know, really breaking the fourth wall there for a bit. I mean, it would also be kind of like a thanks, I hate it kind of situation, but still. Now, let's get some more health. Yas. We're going for the yasification of this. There we go, yas. Murder, 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 murder! Yay! Sweet, delicious murder. Okay. Yas! I mean, to be fair, you're going Yas here, Lithaya. It's like, the first time I heard that whole Yas thing was with the Lion King meme, with all of them going Yas, and apparently that is a very gay thing, but for me it was just the funniest shit ever, seeing a bunch of lions going like Yas. And now it's become such a part of my vocab that I recently had someone go like, so, are you in the LGBTQ community? And a part of me doesn't even know the answer to that question, because I've been attracted to non-binary people. So technically that makes me not straight anymore, but I'm also really not into guys. So I'm not sure what I am at this point. You know what I mean? And I was just so confused that they were like, oh, you're saying that Yas thing. Are you gay? I'm like, well, that would be new. I don't know. Sweet Caroline. Oh, another song for you, Sweet Caroline. I don't know Sweet Caroline that well. I am a horrible, horrible Philistine. So I have to veto that one, I'm afraid. But you can still throw songs my way to see if I can rhythmically make something that fits the moment that I'm playing something. Crazy witches everywhere. Crazy witches, look, they got white hair. Throwing balls at my face. Holy shit, so annoying. Can you please fuck off? Indiana Jones theme. There you go. No. What is happening here? Oh no. See, now you're starting to see the chaos of certain levels and how it's going to get gradually worse. Like, the Temple of Styx is the worst part of this game, but Elysium already primes you for that.
Power of Olympus.
Let's see, let's upgrade my black metal boon. More black metal. Yes. Ooh, that is a big-ass vortex right there. I like that. I love that. Okay, let's go to the store, shall we? Balls in your face. Yeah. Here we go. I know what you are, but... St. Sally, that is weirdly wholesome. Let me read that out. I know what you are. Pull up a chair for this one, because it will blow your mind.
You are human.
No way. I dig it. Thank you. Balls in your face. It's like, should I say that with a Duke Nukem voice? Like, balls in your face. I have two kinds of sex. The sex I had with your mother, and the sex I had with your father.
That thing got better, huh?
Those memes have been going around. Okay, premium vintage, there we go. Oh, look at this. This little bottle right there. That is a bottle of, that's not ambrosia, but the other one. And I'll figure out the name when it comes up. But no, I agree with you, St. Sally. There's, if you don't want to label certain things, then don't. I'm quite the same, honestly. But regarding that bottle I just picked up, that is the kind of bottle that you can give to someone to show your appreciation of them. And that is how you build relationships. That bottle has alcohol. An ambrosia has alcohol, so if this game has taught us one thing, is that if you want to be good friends with people, you give them alcohol. It's not about the conversations, it's not about the deeper connections you build, it's not about the, you know, the inherent togetherness of people, no. It's about the amount of alcohol that you give someone. That's what this game teaches us. That is what Supergiant Games wants us to think. Very, 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 very good advice. If I would say so myself. Now let's fight some annoying bull and a king that is not really a king. Yes, nectar is alcohol, actually. Yes, nectar is absolutely alcohol. Thank you, Marcel Slamon. Thank you for that. So yeah, it's like, you know, alcohol is obviously what makes the world go round. Okay, so now we're gonna bump into Theseus. And he annoys me to no end.
Mysterious, and I shall smite you back into the lowest depths of hell.
Okay, so I hate him with a thousand passions. For those of you who have no idea who this is, Theseus is the hero that beat the Minotaur in the labyrinth. Yes, Theseus is all levels of annoying, isn't he? And, well, basically he saved that same Minotaur from dying in Tartarus. So, that's why the Minotaur is now a part of his team. Which is weirdly canon, but also weirdly fucked up. Anyway, let's kick their asses. And this song is killer. Da. they are testing you, Zagreus. That's the point of this game, but thank you for being aware of it. Okay, that is Theseus. There we go. Basically, for those of you who want to play this game yourself, just make sure you get the blade dash and the black metal upgrade, because that is the one thing that will make you fucking invincible in this game. Like, this, it almost is game-breaking, as you can see. Because I was talking to you guys about having God mode on, but honestly, I have not even needed God mode up until this point, because you can still die in God mode. Oh, he says thank you before I die. That's interesting, before he dies.
Hope you enjoyed the show out in the stands.
But the thing with God mode in this game is that you're not invulnerable. It basically just gives you an extra boost when you die. Like, when you die, it actually gives you some extra health for the next run you're playing. So it's not exactly God mode. Because God mode in the past used to be invulnerability and you can just blaze through the game without trying. But as you can see, I do need to put some effort in. Okay, so what is this happening in the chat? Theseus also gets a pass from me. No, thank you. No, absolutely. Honestly, Saint Sally, if I would have to pick between Theseus and Asterius, I would pick Asterius because he's the hot one. Yes, the bull is the hot one. Also, fun fact, look at that little orange dude in the crowd.
You are my biggest fan.
He is the only one who has a little Zagreus banner. And he gives you a smile when you win. And I think that's adorable. I think that's really awesome. Let's see. Best character in this game is Dusa. Oh yeah, Dusa is so sweet. I love Dusa. She is so jittery.
Cerberus is patiently at work instead of resting here.
Yeah, Cerberus is at work. Let's see. What else do we get? Okay. Oh yeah. And now I'm going to use the final thing that I always pick at the Temple of Styx, and that's the Lucky Tooth. It's in the top right corner, for those of you who play this game. It's the one you get from Skelly when you give him nectar, and it gives you an extra life. As you can see at the bottom now, I have 4 extra lives besides a full health meter, and you're gonna need it against Hades. Because that battle's tough. Dusa, look, Dusa is not for dating. Dusa is just for sweet conversation and cuddles. She is the sweetest, and she deserves good things. And her jitteriness kind of reminds me of how I can be when I want to do things right and when I am a perfectionist myself at times. So that's why I feel for Dusa. Here we go. We have reached the Temple of Styx. Look, it's the pupper. Patiently sitting there. I'm not going to battle him, though. For those of you who have never seen this game before and who have no clue what this is all about, Cerberus guards the gates of hell, normally. He is the one that you have to go through if you want to go in there. However, in this case, Cerberus is obviously your puppy, and you don't want to fight your puppy. So what I got to do now is go into the hallways here. These are the sewers.
Where would I be?
Yeah, and I would have to find a satyr sack. This is the moment you make ball jokes, Saint Sally, because it's literally... I'm still not sure what is in a satyr sack. All I know is that it smells filthy and Cerberus likes it.
I'll take this one.
And I love dogs, but dogs can eat the filthiest fucking things in the world if they put their minds to it. And I don't want to know what is in a satyr sack. I feel that it's like hellish haggis or something. But basically, you gotta go through these dungeons, go through these sewers to find the satyr sack, give it to him. No, exactly. It's not an 18 plus stream. We cannot go there. The cursing is already bad enough. But basically, if I give Cerberus the satyr sack, then he can. Then he will just go away, and he'll be eating that somewhere in a corner, and then you can pass him. I've already gone too far before. No, that's fair.
Let's see.
Let's go for the first sewer. And this part is actually really hard. Because right now I'm not facing the enemies that are the hardest, but there are enemies who have the annoying quality of poison. And that poison drains your life meter really, really quickly. Now, here we have a whole bunch of rats. Rats are not my biggest concern, like I can take these ones easily. But there's also big rats, oversized rats, and they have poison and they will murder you. They will murder you relentlessly. Here we go. There's the oversized rats. Look at the green stuff that's coming off them. Yeah, that's not a fun time. You want to avoid that a lot, basically. It's like, stay away from the green shit. It won't make your life better. Oh, no. No, you stay away. But I now have the uppercut, which punches people away. Oh, I'm poisoned. Shit. Okay. Wasn't too bad, but still. Poison running through our veins, yeah.
They're poison! They're poison running through my veins! I can't help them!
Well,
if they go out, I'll break their face with their poison! You're green! With, you're green! Laser eyes! Your blood!
I don't know what to make out of that. I'm still... I gotta workshop this one. Oh, there is a satyr, actually. A satyr just dropped in. Those guys I try to kill as soon as I can because they actually spit at you. You heard them make the sound, and then they spit poison in your face. It's really rank. It has to be the last of this lot. See that? Oh, did you just see that? Did you see the guy spitting from the side? Like, that is pure poison. He just spits that in your face. Oh, no. That is filthy.
Idiot.
Die. Okay, here we go.
That's something.
Well, at least I got a life up. Still, no satyr sack to be found here. Well, time to go back to the beginning and pick another tunnel. There we go. So, the loop here basically is go into a tunnel, find if you can find something cool, and if not, go back again. But you can buy some pretty big upgrades here. For example, I just upgraded my blade dash by 2 levels. That's definitely helping.
You're green with slime.
Yeah, that actually works.
You'll die in time. My spit will kill your death. My thrill. I wanna vomit, but I wanted to.
Oh my god, no. No, I'm not gonna go here. There's very specific sections of the internet dedicated to this, and I don't wanna be a part of that. Oh no. Wait for it. See, this is two of those fucks. Why don't you die? Come on. Yes, thank you. Okay. Now we're gonna go here.
Hey, a satyr sack already.
And, yes, Slamon, that is true. The little shrines do cure the poison, but in my case, with my playing style, with the speedy playing style, it sometimes actually pays off to just keep doing the murdery thing and just run through them, you know? Because here we go, blade dash level up. Like, by the time that you heal your poison, someone else has already spat at you and you're poisoned again. You know, it's just this continuous loop. But I found the satyr sack.
Cerberus can never get enough of this stuff.
And?
Goes down smooth.
I don't want to know what's in there. It's so fucking filthy. Oh no. Okay, one final boon before I'm heading into Hades.
We cannot effectively communicate with Charon from Olympus, but he is amenable to certain trades and seems unfettered by your father's influence.
Yeah, you know, Charon is a free man. Free enterprise, dude. Let's see, last stand. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to fight my father.
Vigilant Cerberus decides to look the other way this once.
Also, can we just agree that the portrait of Cerberus, just look at how happy one of those heads looks, the one at the front, is just such a happy pupper. I feel that, like, that the other two are like, murder, 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 and that one guy is like, is that a ball? Like, just the happiest little dude ever. I love it. Cerberus vanquished. Not really. Well, here we go.
Time to go.
Ring. Now, two things can happen. Or I need to fight this battle for real, and I think that's what's going to happen. Or I might have fought the battle enough that we're actually going to head to the credits sequence. And if that is the case, then you guys are going to hear one of the most beautiful songs in the whole game.
I guess there's
promise
one
this
thing
time.
To do. Isn't that so, Father?
I must admit to something, boy. Achilles taught you reasonably well. I expected that if anyone could train you into martial competence, it would be him.
Well, that's something, I guess. Pass.
You didn't expect that one day I would end up using everything I learned from him against you.
I anticipate more than you know. But Achilles merely practiced against mortals. Now you practice against me.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the final battle of the game. Hades. And I feel that I'm slightly OP. Because I have a lot of extra lives and I get the strongest blade dash that you can have. Oh my god, I don't think I've ever beaten him this quickly.
Wretches of the underworld, I command you now to rise and fight.
Like, this is not just god mode, because I thought it would be god mode, but god mode only works once you die. This is all just based on the fact that I got the right boons here. Holy crap. Oof. Okay, so what can we conclude after this? Ares' blade dash is broken. Look at this. I'm just continuously holding the Y button and dashing through Hades, and this is what's happening. I'm not even pushing the button anymore, I'm just dashing. Wow. Okay. Yeah, this is the boon combination that breaks the game. That's pretty clear. Wow. Holy moly. Okay, that was his first form.
Tell me why.
Okay, now he's going into his aggressor form. And then you just gotta hide for his lasers once in a while. But most of it is actually pretty manageable still. Are you telling me that I'm maybe even able to finish this without losing a life? What is going on? This is ridiculous. I don't think I've ever had a run in which it goes so well. Like, you guys are watching me play this and now it's going so well. What the hell? Like I said, I'm not calling myself a good gamer at all, but this is ridiculous. Wow. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Big boy lasers there. Okay.
Let's have it out there for you.
Nah. Are you kidding me? Okay, this is historical. I've never had this. I've never won without losing a life.
My kin would be the one to do this to me.
Holy shit. Duck? Well, you cannot really duck. You can only dash away behind a pillar in this case. There's no ducking in this game. It's a good piece of advice, though. Lasers. Nice run. Yeah, this is... Thank you. This is ridiculous. That you of all of my kin would be the one to do this to me.
Ungrateful.
Well, you know, I would be more grateful if you weren't a horrible dad that literally scolded everything I did for the whole of my life, but you know, whatever. This is what happens, I guess. Okay, so I played for 34 minutes and 17 seconds. Yeah, here we go. I got 3 power boosts here, so that's my best score so far. This is really, really good. And you witnessed it live. Damn.
Blood.
Holy crap. And like I said, just to reiterate, yes, I have God mode on, but God mode literally only goes into play the moment you die. But I haven't died. So I think we can now just conclude that if we get the right combination of boons from Ares, this game is breakable to the max. Okay, story time. We are gonna go to meet my mother. Mummy. Mama. Mummy. Mother. Mummy. Okay, so I think this is kind of pretty. This is what Greece looks like the moment you leave hell, between brackets. And this scene will never disappoint.
Wow.
Pretty. And as I told you, in this story, Zagreus' mother is not Nyx, it is Persephone, and that is the one we're looking for now. We are now gonna see Zagreus' mom, Persephone, in the overworld. You're back.
Mother!
Okay.
You can't do this to me, Mother. You said Father is no fool, and neither are you. There has to be a way to fix this. Not just with you and Father, but with everyone. There has to be a way.
There you go.
You have your father's stubbornness. Listen to me. You're endangering everything you care about by coming here. Don't you understand? Besides...
What? Besides what? Tell me, please.
The truth is that I like it here, Zacharias. I have done well for myself on my own. And your father, he has his domain to look after. The feelings he once had for me, feelings we shared, they fade with time. You'll understand someday.
Yeah, that is very much something a bittered adult would say. Yeah. Not a good look on you, Persephone.
No, I won't be understanding anything of the sort. Father still loves you, I'm sure of it. And he owes you an apology, damn it. I cannot make amends with you on his behalf. Something only you can do together.
Go, Zacharias. I'm pro everything he's doing right now.
What do you mean he still loves me, Zacharias? How would you know?
Because I'm his blasted son, that's how I know. But trust me, isn't ever good enough, I know that too. I'll prove it to you, Mother. Just you wait and see.
Okay, so for those of you wondering what is happening right now, Zacharias obviously cannot stay in the overworld for too long because he is bound to the underworld. So every time you go up here to talk to his mother, the conversations are relatively short because he will be summoned and drawn back into the underworld again because unfortunately he is not a human. He is a creature of the underworld and those are not allowed to stay on the human surface. So basically what you see now is him dying. And he continuously tries to go up, talk to his mother for a bit, then die again, and that's the loop. That's he desperately wants to see her and wants her to come back.
Oh, you're fading, son. You don't need to prove anything to me. Please don't do anything rash. All of us made our choices. Now we have to live with them. Isn't it enough to know that I'm safe? That I'm content to be alone?
Yeah, that would have been enough if that was your legit desire, but unfortunately you've also said some other things over time, and no, Persephone, that isn't enough. You gotta get your life back together.
No. It's not enough for me, because this blasted family, it cannot just keep hiding from its problems, running from them. We're stuck with one another. We have to do everything we can for one another.
Dudes get a point.
Oh, my dear boy.
Interesting, now she starts to see what he means. And obviously, for dramatic effect, that is the moment he dies.
We have to.
See?
No, not yet.
He gets taken by the Styx, and thus, we end up, once again, in the House of Hades.
God damn it all. Again.
Again. There we go. The House of Hades. Okay, by the way, Hypnos, this guy right here, he is the king of saying the wrong things at the wrong time. However, I think I've kind of exhausted all his dialogue options, but let's see what he says.
I was just resting my eyes. You won't tell anybody, right?
He sleeps on the job. I mean, he is sleep. It's okay, Hypnos. We know you are sleep, so you're allowed to sleep on the job. Puppy! I'm gonna pet you.
More pets? More pets.
Always more pets. I hear Dusa.
Achilles, I need your help.
Look, there's Dusa. She's cleaning. And she always is a bit spooked when you talk to her. I think that's kind of adorable. I'm gonna give her some nectar. Here you go.
Hey, Dusa. Here's some more of this really, really good nectar for you. Please keep up the wonderful work, and more importantly, keep being your wonderful self.
I mean, this is wholesome as fuck. I love this. I love how wholesome Zacharias can be.
I'm really very flattered, Prince, but I've just been so busy lately that I haven't even had a chance to try the last bottle you gave me, so you want this back? Maybe for someone else?
No.
Please, it's yours. Besides, you must have some time off coming up when you can enjoy it, don't you?
Probably.
Oh, I mean, maybe I do. I think maybe I do, except nobody's told me anything about that. besides, there's so much work to do around the house still, I just can't leave everything like this.
Dusa basically is never not working, and it's a bit concerning. She is pushing herself a bit too much, maybe. Maybe. Just a little bit.
Well, you enjoy, all right?
All right. Okay, hello, Achilles.
What is it, lad? What's wrong? What can I do?
He also has a relaxing voice. I like that.
Let me in Father's chambers, please. That's high atop the list of things I'm not to do for anyone, and under any circumstances. What is it you need? I've never even been in there myself.
Okay, so Zagreus wants to go inside his father's chamber to find evidence of Hades still loving Persephone. Yeah, Achilles is great in this game. Achilles is wholesome and very strong and heroic, and he's a great dude. Great character in this game.
I don't know, but if I know Father, and I think I do, he's got to have something of hers in there. Of Mother's. She still doesn't get it, doesn't believe me about him, and I said I'd prove it, that he cares for her.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
All
good outfit.
Slow down, I understand. Look, this can get me in a lot of trouble like you've no idea. And not just me, so be careful. Thank you.
Oh my god, I just got the key to the room. Oh no. What am I gonna find?
The Stoic lord and master of the house possesses wealth beyond imagining, a portion of which he has used for a crisp set of attire for every passing day. I knew it. It's just capes.
He only has capes. Okay, there's a certain point where you're fighting Hades, and actually Zagreus makes this fourth wall breaking comment saying, like, so are you just gonna burn capes every day? How many of those do you have? And obviously now I see the clothing accessories and it's just capes. It's like he only has capes. He has nothing else. Here we go.
In his lord father's very private chambers, Zagreus, the lock removing prince, discovers a most delicately painted likeness of none other than Persephone herself. A coat of dust suggests it has remained here for some time.
There we go. Hades still has an image of Persephone on his nightstand. I mean, that's a pretty clear indicator, isn't it? Also, hello, not sure why Art. Welcome, so good to see you here. Well, the game is going great. I just had a successful run, and I'm now in between two runs. So you can be cozy with us for a little bit. I'm couch gaming and chilling. And just talking everyone through, well, one of my favorite games, Hades. There you go.
He's never stopped thinking of her. Ugh, what a fool.
Yeah, he never stopped thinking of her. I mean, duh. He is just infatuated with her, but he is also a stubborn asshole, so he doesn't dare to admit it out loud. It's just what it is. There we go. I get the proof we needed. Couch gang, absolutely. I mean, it's nice.
What do you need? I did, thank you.
Indeed, yeah, Hades sleeps on a stone slab with a stone pillow. I think that is kind of funny as well. Oh, also, a little detail. Often you have these shades standing around here in the corner or in different places, and they also sometimes have really funny dialogue, so I'm not sure what this is going to be, but...
What are those shades muttering about?
Just look at him. Do you really think he has what it takes? Cause of death? Wolves. I'm not sure if you're the one to talk about someone having what it takes if you're fighting wolves. Oh, hello, husbando.
Than my blade, the one I'm borrowing from Father anyway. It revealed to me an older aspect of itself, of Nemesis. Nyx never mentions her. Have you two ever met?
In case you haven't noticed, most of us who sprang from Nyx, we are not exactly close. Nemesis is fully occupied meeting out justice on the surface. Our paths are not designed to cross. And based on everything I know, that's fine with me.
Yeah, Nemesis is the goddess of revenge. And, justice is a loose term with her as well. So there's something to be said about him not wanting to be a part of that.
I'm sure she's lovely then.
Oh, what's this? Hot for me. Than. Yeah, there you go. I'm so happy right now. There was a woman at the bookstore, and she told me I'm the nicest person she talked to in a long time. And, well, not sure why, Art. That is... I mean, that is really, really... It's kind of pretty. It's pretty that she told you that, but it's also kind of... well, sad, in a way, because then... she probably has not had that kind of kindness in a long time. And it's, like, I mean, it's nice to get a compliment like that, but a part of me is also like, yeah, but that should be the norm, right? Like, shouldn't we be a bit kinder to each other? But then again, I'm a stupid hippie, so what do I know? Here we go. Let's go back to the game real quick. Okay, so I just talked to Achilles. I talked to Than. I've done my share of things.
Still up there.
Okay, what? Here is the contractor. This is also an interesting part of the game. You can buy stuff to upgrade the world. So, for example, here, if I would put money, or in this case, jewels, into this, I will be finding more special prizes along the way. Like, I will be finding more treasure chests with bigger rewards. But I'm kind of saving up because I know that I have to do certain things to help Achilles and to help Orpheus. So that's why I kind of want to save up my stuff to be sure. But at the same time, I'm looking the way I showed you. Angry goth being kind. Yeah, that's like you showed me your outfit earlier. And indeed, it is about right. There you go. Oh, also, ladies and gentlemen, meet Mommy.
Nix, if hypothetically I felt that some injustice had been dealt to someone who deserved a better lot, say that they were subjected to too harsh a punishment for all eternity, don't I have some of my father's authority to do something about it?
Now that you have regained your access privileges to the administrative chamber, child, yes, that is the level of authority you hypothetically possess again.
I love how she says hypothetically. Like, she knows that he's going to be using that power, but she's like, no, I'm politically correct. I'm saying, yes, hypothetically, you have this power. Nix is absolutely a smash for me as well. Like, Nix is... Mommy. That
but
kind of vibe.
How can I possibly find anything in there? The place is wall-to-wall packed in parchments. I have no idea where to look.
Yeah, that's a problem.
You can be made aware. Though, use discretion if and when you need to exercise this power, and make certain that the time is right. Now, are we understood?
Oh no, I'm not sorry at all, but that was actually a meme. Like, you know, walking up to a pretty lady going, Mommy, sorry, Mommy, sorry, Mommy, sorry. You know, it's a strong
we are.
Thing. Also, another hot lady coming up, ladies. I know that both Wannabe Cat and Saint Sally are ranking, and this is my waifu right here.
Megara, I have to ask you something, please. We really need to talk.
For once, I think you're right. Although I'm curious, what is it that you think we have to talk about?
Hi. Sorry.
I still have feelings for you. At least, I think I do. Isn't there some way for us to, you know, work through all of this?
In spite of everything that's happened, and that's happening right now, what are the outcomes, Zagreus? Either you eventually succeed and leave this place, or else what, exactly?
Ah. More Nix for you guys. For me, Meg is like, hi.
I haven't thought that far ahead. But I don't think it has to be this way. I don't hate you, Meg. I don't think I can ever hate you.
Also, I feel that this is kind of sweet, this exchange. I mean, Meg is playing hard ass, as she obviously needs to be in her role, but Zagreus actually is burying her heart saying, I don't hate you and I still love you. And I think that's kind of sweet.
Despite my best intentions, unfortunately, I don't know that I can say the same. Look, I'm at a very difficult point in my career. I need to focus on that now. Do we understand each other?
I think so.
He just got denied.
Here's what I caught lately.
But to be fair, yeah. Well, chicks got a point, and they have a history that wasn't exactly most... smooth. So I get her hesitation. She has a good point. Also, is that... Oh, that's Orpheus on the board.
Orpheus got on the board.
Okay, you see that little board there with the gold star? Like, every time you do a run and you return against someone else's employee of the month, and or employee of the... however they measured time in that place. And I think it's kind of adorable. Like, there's also a way that you can have Nix and Than, Cerberus, of course. It's just a subtle little detail that they change around every time. Now, let's see. Is there anything I can do here? Is there an upgrade I can do, maybe? Yes, God's Pride. Thank you. Flop. 20%. There we go. Because, basically this whole mirror, everything in this mirror is meant to help you increase your character stats. And what I just increased is the chance of getting epic boons, like the ones, like, for example, that blade dash that just helped me destroy Hades.
Feeling good.
So, I think, my good friends, we're now at the, we're already this far into the stream, damn. I kind of want to get something to drink real quick. So, let me do that, and I think I might be able to cram in another run because, well, the last run took a bit longer because I was explaining everything, and now I can just play and hang out with you guys. So, let me just quickly get something to drink. Hang on for a bit. No, not a bum show. I'm going to stand up like this now. F you. Oh my gosh. The one time your pants drops off, the one time, and it's on stream and everyone can see your butt crack, but now they can still hear what I'm saying. You know, the horror. It is kind of convenient that the kitchen is right here, though. Giant balls. Big titties. Giant balls! Okay. Here we go. Oh, who is leaving? I missed your bum, aw. Oh, okay, wannabe cat. Well, have a good one. Sleep well, and have a good night. And see you again on Tuesday when we're going to be writing a new song. Yay! So, or if you're able to make it, of course. So, have a good one. Sleep well. Now, let's have a drink. That's better. Now, let's see what weapon we need to pick. I turned off the stream for your dinner. Well, by accident, Marcel. It wasn't that bad. Now, let's see her. Hello, Skelly.
Let's see what you can do in terms of hitting me, pal.
Okay, boyo. Oh, I can use the shield.
Need more darkness with this.
Greetings.
There we go. The shield also worked in my favor. Like, I tried the shield before, and it worked really well. So, I think I'm just gonna do a run with the shield now. Also, I boosted the shield to get the power of chaos. So, that's pretty neat. Okay. Let's do it. Let's go for the shield run. The shield is your favorite weapon, Marcel. That's nice. Oh, and the same for you, Saint Sally. That's awesome. I don't hate it, per se. I'm not the biggest fan, but I don't necessarily hate it. And apparently I can do this with two heat gauges. Oh, that's kind of nice. Let's do that then.
What could go wrong?
The thing is that I don't use the throw that much. I know some people really like... Oh, okay, sorry. I thought you meant that was also your favorite. No, because like I said, I think the fists are my favorite, absolutely. I don't really use the bull rush that much. I tend to go... quite fast, so the dash strike deals 50% damage in a larger area. Okay, I'll take it.
Bonk. Let's see how this goes.
Bonk, bonk, bonk. Oh, that was nice. Oh, a chaos gate in the first room. Well, sure, okay.
I can take it.
Hi, Master Chaos. Shield and the spirit, yeah. It's epic right up to Hades. Like, the shield being epic up to Hades, Marcel? You mean that? Because, like I said, I did beat Hades, but that was mostly because, once again, I had the blade dash. I'm gonna use the same strategy again. Oh no, I'm an idiot. I just realized I didn't pick the right trinket, and now I already have Skelly's extra life. Right here. You know what? Fuck it. Let's do a chaos run. Let's go around.
From the rumblings of the earth, I have deduced your father himself stands against you when at last you are about to leave these depths. It must be quite an interaction between you. Have I deduced correctly?
Yes, you deduced correctly, Chaos.
That's right, Master Chaos. My father personally takes it upon himself to stop me in the event none of his underlings beat him to it. He can be a handful.
You can basically nuke everything from a distance with the throw. I really need to get the right upgrades then, because that sounds awesome. I never did that. Okay,
future interactions, the small round catalyst which I provided you. The one in the shape you call an egg. It shall serve no purpose there at all. Yet if you succeed, then it shall bring us some amusement, you shall not.
Okay, so the question is if I can beat the game.
Was I supposed to respond there?
with the egg.
Okay, we can do that. For the next for the next three encounters, each time you special, you get hit for -4 health. Ah, fuck it, I'll take it. I mean, I don't really use my special much anyway, so I'll just go for more darkness. There we go. But the special, you guys say that there's a way to turn it into a nuclear device on a distance. That is legit interesting. But then I would need to find the right boons for that, I'd say. Okay, here we go. Ah, no, that wasn't too bad. Standing. Who is, well, you know, now I'm going for random boons. Oh, I don't like Zeus's boons, but I'll take it. Let's see what we got. Oh, whoops. Oh yeah, I shouldn't use that special, because I get hurt. Murder, 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 I'm murdering you. Here we go. Oh, what is Zeus giving me?
You must forgive the Lady Demeter her scornfulness, nephew, for she is still recovering after the sudden disappearance of her daughter. Though it was quite some time ago, the girl, poof, just vanished. I try to lighten up the mood around it every now and then, but no, a sore spot still.
Well, Zeus, you're being a bit of an insensitive dick. I mean, if your kid suddenly disappears, that does something to someone, okay? Thunder Flourish. Your special causes a lightning bolt to strike nearby foes. Is that the one you guys tend to use? I don't know. Not sure if I'm feeling that one. I'm gonna go for the electric shot.
Thunder time.
Thunder time? Seriously, Zagreus? Okay, let's upgrade our health a little bit. Yeah. Murder, 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 murder. Oh no. No, no, no. Here we go. What is happening? Okay, yeah, here we go.
The boon I got from Chaos has a new effect.
Oh, now I can do my special. Yay, okay, so it does throw pretty far. That's pretty neat. Okay, am I going to talk to my good friend Sisyphus? Going Ares for special and Athena on dash. Yeah, well, that makes sense because Athena obviously gives you the reflect dash. And then the special being Ares also makes sense because his dashes tend to be, or his things mostly inflict doom. So then, yeah, that checks out, actually. I'm not gonna go for Sisyphus. I first just wanna raise up my character a little bit and get some more HP and that kind of stuff. Like, the only thing I would use the special characters for now is get money so I can raise my stats, but then I'd rather raise my stats directly and fight some more monsters. Here we go. Got a key. I got a key! Let's see. Oh yeah, here we go. Athena. And a boss battle. What is the boss battle here? Oh, it's a witch.
It's that damn wretched sneak.
Yeah, he calls it a sneak, but I believe it's a bit of a witch, isn't it? It's a bit of a witch, isn't it? Boy, governor. Okay, what do we... Nice. Okay, there we go.
You stab me, I stab you.
Hello, Athena.
I'm pleased to see your father's stubbornness is manifest in you as such determination, Zagreus. My blessing be with you.
Okay. I like her. She's nice. You know what? I'll just go for the safe choice, which is the attack that deflects.
Here, fishies.
Here, fishy, fishy, fishy. Here, fishy. Here, Fihi. Fihi. Fibs. Murph and the Fibs.
I got one.
Fink. The Murph and the Fibs. Okay, well, that's one. If you know what meme that was from, I was just doing, then you are a real trooper. There we go. Oh, wait, no. Okay. That is not what I was anticipating. Oh, there we go. Murder. Okay. Watch out, slutty little calf coming in.
You give those musty sheets and corpses a fair fighting chance down there, you hear me, Zag? Or just in case you need a hand.
Actually, I'm pondering putting him on the special, yeah. But at the same time, I'm gonna go for strong drink. Because that's the one that makes all fountains restore all your health and give you the bonus damage, which is a bit more fundamental. But if I meet Dionysus again, I might actually put him on the special. Yeah, because I do agree with you, Slamon, that it is a good idea. Because the drunk is obviously also a way to inflict hurt. It's just that I first always try to pick the boons that give you like long-term advantages. So if I'm, for example, in Elysium and almost out of health, then I can use the fountain to at least have a fighting chance, that kind of situation. Here we go. Where's this going? You're all armored, aren't you? You all think you're hot shit, aren't you? Don't you? Look at you. Like, you think you're hot shit. But you're not. I'm murdering you. I'm murdering each and every one of you. I'm murdering your face off. Oh no. What? No. Oh no. Ha, here we go.
Gods grant me strength.
Yeah, divine strike. Now, let's see. Cookie jar? Cookie jar. I'm taking a cookie from the cookie jar, father.
Allow me, boy, to introduce some of my
lord. I always think that these time challenges are like, don't touch the cookie jar. I'm touching the cookie jar, and then he sends out monsters. Just made me giggle. Cookie jar! Nah. Can we just agree that these guys are just annoying? You're not even a real threat, you're just annoying.
That's quite enough.
Well, got some money from the cookie jar, that's pretty good. Money! Okay. Whoop. Here we go, that's pretty neat. What did you do tonight? I murdered a whole bunch of demons, slayed my father twice. Was a good night. Well, I'm not sure if I'm gonna slay him twice, though. I mean, right now I still don't have the combination of boons I just had, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. I feel that this is also going a lot quicker because I'm explaining less on the side, obviously. Go. Where? Also, I'm still not entirely sure what these fat enemies are supposed to represent, because most enemies have, like, some logical explanation as to why they're here. But these are just Big Chungus. I'm like, I was pretty sure that Big Chungus was not a part of Greek mythology.
Colorful.
Unless Big Chungus has been a part of our lives for way longer than we originally anticipated. I guess gluttony? Yeah, that would be a good description for myself, absolutely. I mean, I guess, I think it would be the same, but I never really found a good explanation for it, honestly. Like I said, with the numbskulls, for instance, I just found out that it was apparently numbskulls and that is what the curse work was based on. And the hands are apparently just, apparently those are just the ones guarding the prisoners. Those are witches. There you go. Nah. Come on. Yes.
A centaur heart.
Neat. I like it. No, I'm gonna go for the shop. I'm not too crazy about... let's see. They're supposed to be decadent nobles from Greek city-states, I think. Oh, that could be. Silent Dreamer is awake. That would be a good description, honestly. I'm willing to take that as canon now, even if there is no logical explanation for it. Mate? Let's see.
Let's make some waves.
Level up for that. Here we go. Hi, Karen. Riveting.
Couldn't have said it better myself.
Like, that's why I like him. Time. He is just a bit of a sassy little dork. It's like, I couldn't have said it better myself, Charon. Aw, to Tisiphone.
Murder.
Okay, so for those of you who have no idea who she is from a, from the perspective of history, apparently she is the one that captures the murderers in hell, and that's because she got murdered by her loved one, and there's a whole tragic backstory to that. So the only word she utters is murder. Murder, 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 murder. That's what she says. And in a weird way, it is obviously kind of stupid to just hear one word, but her voice actress went hard, and I'm feeling it. I feel that she is really tragic because of it. It works. Unfortunately, I do have to slaughter her now. If I can, because, well... I'm just fighting her with basically only my weapon, so... Like, I do have the reflection... Okay, there we go. Oh yeah, and every time you beat her, she makes the arena a bit smaller. So, if you would, for example, fight her on a distance, then she will force you to get up close, because the arena gets smaller with every consecutive effort, basically. Here we go. Okay, I'm doing a pretty good job. Apparently my dash strike is hitting hard, so that helps. Here we go. Yeah, sorry Tisiphone, I feel bad, but you're going down. Yeah, there we go. Got her. Fun fact, by the way.
Glad that's over.
If you keep playing this, because I played that in my other game, she will learn a new word. And the new word is Zagreus. And she's like, Zagreus, murder! But you do have to play over 100 tries,
I think.
Do bathe
yourself in magma when you get to Asphodel.
Well, that's not very nice to wish upon someone. Then again, it's Hades. He isn't very nice. Do bathe yourself in magma when you get to Asphodel.
Broke out of Tartarus. Check.
Oh wow, I think I just saw some lightning outside. Not sure about you guys, but I just saw a flash. So, if we get a storm tonight, that would be kind of nice. Smell. Good to sleep to that. Shall I do the Chaos Gate, guys? Yeah, I'll do the Chaos Gate, sure. Let's see, another Chaos Gate. Two Chaos Gates in one run. That's new. Hello, Master Chaos. How are you doing? How is the weather here in the infernal darkness? Dark? What a surprise.
In the name of Hades.
Ooh, that is so awesome! I'm so happy. Yeah, I mean, I love thunderstorms as long as I don't have to cycle in them, so I'm good with this. Let's see. My attack deals plus 32 damage? That sounds pretty neat. Although, you know what? I'm gonna follow Marcel's advice and try to focus on my special. So, if I do this, reward previews are hidden, but afterwards my special hits plus 48%. That is pretty sizable. I'll take it. But then obviously I don't know what I'm getting in the rooms that follow, but... Fuck it, this is a chaos run anyway. I'm just gonna see how far I can get with chaos booms. And not a lot of planning. Okay. These guys are armored as heck, though. Fortunately, my dash strike hits like a truck. Oh. The floor is lava! Let's see, I don't like to see the red dots move across the country in a slow manner on Bayerradar. It means a lot of work in the morning. Yeah, when you work in insurance, that checks out. Well, to be fair, I mean, I would not expect that this is the kind of massive storm that would break half the country. But the moment I say that out loud, there's probably gonna be whole cities wiped out tomorrow or some shit, I don't know. Massive floods, everyone died, oh no, to humanity, and all because Tom said it wasn't that bad. Okay, I'm sorry. Here we go, let's get some jewels. Okay, so I can pick between an eye and an eye. I'll pick the eye. It's like, I have no idea what I'm picking. Ooh, that bass line. Here we go. Ah. Okay, wait for that guy to come down. I think we're gonna... I hope we're gonna fight the Medusa boss, because I actually really, really like the Medusa boss. Also, that soundtrack is a bomb. Oh, okay. Numbskulls and witches. Or we could get a witch's circle, that's fine too. No, this ain't too bad. Ah. No, we're not gonna go for the cookie jar. Well, pick the eye or the eye. I'll pick the eye. You know what? I'll do daring. I'll pick the eye. I see, exactly. Sally got there. Oh, here we go. Here's the witch's circle. Okay, so I told you guys I got reflect, right? Check it out. Volkerball! I'm just throwing back all their balls at them. It's a bit like saying you like e-girls and eye-ladies.
In the name of Hades.
For those of you... You know, e-girls and eye-ladies, we all know those. Is no one going to take it?
Off we go.
Yeah, thunderstorms are amazing. Let's see. Ah! Oh, they're incredibly... They're all incredibly armored! But now I'm throwing... You know what, Marcel? I'm using your strategy now. I'm throwing out hangovers. And it seems to... Oh, it seems to work as well. This hits like... That is nice. Like, if I can finish it off with some dash strikes. This is working! Girl, this is working! Okay, what? No. This is working, though. What? Yeah, they're definitely amping up the enemy difficulty here. That's good. Okay, here we go. Got a bit of extra.
What's in the well this time?
No, nothing. Okay, now I can at least see what I'm picking. I'm gonna pick some more nectar, definitely. Because nectar also provides me with an upgrade, a level up on another thing. So that's good. Here we go. What are we fighting? Oh, hello, Asbundo!
I sensed your presence here. Let's see who's better at this, Zagreus.
Okay.
Let's slay these wretches quickly. Let's, by all means.
Let's do some shit, this might actually be harder than it looks because... He insta-kills certain enemies now. Yeah, I think Thanatos is going to win this one because he can insta-kill. I cannot insta-kill right now. That is the disadvantage of using this weapon. But... I'll still give him my try, though. Come on. Come on, give me this. Okay, did I win? I actually won. Imagine that. I did not expect to win this one.
Fast, I'll give you that.
Not bad. Thank you. What is this? Oh, there's a fibsh. Where's the fibsh? Murph, fibsh. Okay, there we go. Fibsh. Now, what am I catching? Here, fibshy. Egg. Murph. Yay, I got it!
Huzzah!
Huzzah! Huzzah! I got a fish! Am I going to go to the store, or am I going to go to... Speedy Cousin. Speedy Cousin. Let's go to Speedy Cousin. Let's see what we have here. Oh, okay, so that means that I'm now gonna go into the Hydra. Okay.
Hey, you beat your fastest time fighting through all of that. Not that I'm keeping track. I'm keeping track.
Of course he's keeping track. Okay, let's see. It's like, not that I'm keeping track. I'm keeping track. Because he's a nerd. Now, let's fight Lurney. Lurney the Hydra. He might learn a thing or two. Eh? 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 Oh wow, that was horrible.
Attempting to leave Asphodel of late, Bernie.
Okay, yeah, okay, so I gotta continuously keep throwing that drunk thing at them. So that I can deal extra damage. Oh, and you can stack it. That is actually kinda nice. I didn't know you could stack that. So the moment you throw your shield multiple times, they just become more drunk. That is good. I can see this working. However, the lava is a bit of a problematic element here. Okay. Not too bad, not too bad. Okay, so I can literally keep stacking it. Okay, so you can stack it 5 times apparently. Pretty good. So what did I learn today? You can stack the drunkenness. I mean, it's a bit like in real life. You drink a few beers, you're getting inebriated, you drink a few more, and you end up being incredibly fucking drunk. Stack drunkenness. Imagine that. Wah. Okay, this is... That's good. That is good. I like it. Okay, yeah, that's pretty neat. I like it. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm really happy that I got that reflection thing because I keep bouncing the fireballs back at him. There we go. That was pretty neat. I got him. And, you know, I said I was going to stop streaming at 9, but now I kind of want to finish this run. So I'm going to stream until I finish this run, which is probably going to be, like, what, 10 more minutes? But that's because, you know, it's nice hanging out with you guys, and you seem to enjoy it, so... There you go. I mean, who is still here right now? Because I know some of you are lurking and listening in the background, which is perfectly awesome. And I'm just wondering who is here. Let's see. Bye, there is...
Check.
We're now entering Elysium, the beautiful green kingdom. But also, you guys, I'm pondering on putting this on YouTube, and you know, so people can watch TDW versus Hades, etc., etc. And I like this kind of feedback. Also, Lethaya, the feedback you gave me regarding the audio and everything, like, I wanna make sure that this was a good test and I can learn from this. So I also want to do some investing and see, like, okay, if I can get this thing, then that will help, and if I can get that thing, that will help, you know, that kind of situation. So I'm happy with that kind of feedback, but if there's anything else that stands out to you in terms of image quality or maybe like frames per second or whatever on your end, please tell me, because then I can see if I can get some better stuff. Because I know for a fact that the capture card I'm using right now is not the best in the world. I mean, I'm aware of its limits, so to speak. But I do want to make sure that I'm getting the max out of it, and maybe there's ways for me to fix that in software or something like that. So yeah, there you go. Ah, murder, 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 murder. Okay, here we go. Now, that is nice. After your special hits, the next two attacks deal 80% damage. During your dash, your special is faster and deals 200% damage. Fuck yes, I'm taking it. Okay, so here we go. We have Marcel there. We have Yannicke there. I know that Miss Wizard Potato is still there, and obviously Sally is there. So that's nice. It's nice to know that there's like this little crowd chilling here with me, because that was exactly what this was all for. And if this takes a flight and if more people watch this, if you're watching this on YouTube right now and you think it is fun, then feel free to join me again soon. I'm kind of figuring out when I want to do these game streams based on my schedule, because right now this is an experimental separate episode. I'm not going to do this weekly on Sundays, because not every Sunday I'll be having time. But I do like putting this in and just chilling and talking about stuff that I'm passionate about with you guys. So we'll see what we can make out of this. It's a good learning experience. Show is faster. Okay, so following the advice I got to upgrade my special, and I have a faster special that hits like a truck. I think that might be my saving grace here. Okay, that's good. Got this. Centaur Soul. Gain plus 25 without restoring health. That is good, because I wanted to get it over 300. There we go. Now my health is over 300. That is neat. Because I figured that is like a good threshold to have in terms of health in this game, especially when fighting Hades, because you do need to have enough of that shit. Here we go. Battle, battle, battle. Murder, murder, murder. Yeah, this is nice. See if it can also stack. Okay, so you cannot stack the effects on regular enemies, so it's just on bosses then, I think. But still, not the end of the world. Whoa, did that just hit 600? Whoa! Holy moly, my shield is getting incredibly strong now. That is not bad. Boss battle? Boss battle. Let's go. Butterfly ball, butterfly ball. Oh, hear that guitar kick in. Yeah, the butterfly ball is honestly, from a design perspective, I don't really get why they put this in here. It's like, it kind of just feels like padding, because it's not really a smart, intelligent design boss or whatever. It's like, I like the Asterius fight a lot more, because then you actually have to think on your toes. You know, it's like fighting an actual bull that has a different pattern. This is just, okay, we get a ball of butterflies and a whole bunch of guys spawning around it. I don't know, this feels like the least inspired boss in the game in that regard. Also, I don't really see the significance of the butterflies in that regard. It's like, don't get me wrong, I love butterflies, but it's like, yeah? Why? Okay. There we go. This this ain't the worst. Your foe's ranged attack projectiles are slower. Calculated risk. One of the prophecies. I'll take it.
Both them might.
Okay. Am I going to go for health up or level up? Level up. I need a level up. Yeah, the butterfly ball, man. Ugh. Okay. I feel that we're also nearing the Asterius and Theseus fight, so we can get... So we can, you know, all be annoyed by Theseus' stupid face once again. I mean, I feel that it's kind of nice that everyone I talk to who either played Hades or knows about the game or watched streams, everyone's collectively annoyed by Theseus. I've never met anyone going like, oh man, Theseus is my favorite character in this game. Like, they worked so hard to make people annoy him that we've all got a collective hatred for his arrogance, and I think that is kind of awesome. It's like, okay.
That's Riami.
Also, I've seen way too many memes about Theseus being a very jealous boyfriend over Asterius, which also always makes me giggle. Let's see. No. No. Get on that. Yes. I have no idea what I'm hitting, but apparently I'm hitting something. So actually what you're saying, Marcel, judging on the mythology, is that he was so badass that they kind of wanted to do him dirty in the game.
Good enough to eat.
To balance it out. That's basically what that would mean, I guess. Oh, a challenge of the gods. Perfect, then I can make Zeus angry and get more shit. Here we go. Let's anger Zeus, and then he'll probably fuck a cow or something. I don't know.
He's going to be mad.
I'm gonna go for the full Marcel experience and go for the dash of Athena.
Perhaps you have defied me here in jest, young man. Though in such cases pertinent to my authority, you'll find I lack a sense of humor.
Well,
that's that.
You also lack a sense of self-control considering the amount of children you made that were not with your wife. But hey, what do I know, right? It's like you can almost write down most of Greek mythology by saying, so Zeus got horny, and then shit happened, and shenanigans ensued. These guys are tough as nails, though. They've given him quite a few buffs. Come on. Die. Okay. Yes. Last one. You are the last one. And you're going down. Okay, here we go.
Now, no need to hold such grudges any longer, I suppose. But you just mind yourself around your Uncle Zeus.
Okay, that sounded like a threat, dude. That really sounded like a fucking threat. Okay, let's see. Yeah, money or Zeus? No, money. Money! I need more money. Let's see. Yas. Using some, did Chaos just talk to me while that happened? That was Chaos's voice mid battle. Ah, oh, fucking hell, I thought I had him. I was too late. He recharged. Some of these guys recharge really quickly. That's annoying. I have no idea who I'm fighting at this point. This is a chaotic mess. Kinda exactly the way I like it. Come on. Yes. Okay, good.
Vast riches.
Whew. I think we're now reaching the point that I I'm at the store before the battle with Asarius and Theseus. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Pick up that.
I'll pay for that.
Pick up this. Yes. Pick up that. Pick up this. Let's go, bitch! If Zeus never got horny, we'd never had the epicness that was Kevin Sorbo as Hercules in the TV series. Okay, agreed. At the same time, Kevin Sorbo turned out to be a pretty Republican dude who has been making tweets about not liking the fact that people got exempt from their student loans and all that kind of shit. So, you know, it's like he was pretty epic as Hercules. Unfortunately, as a regular person, he is a bit douchey, you know.
Yes.
That's a shame.
Upon my faith, you'll take not one more step toward the light of day.
No, boo-hoo. Cry me a river.
You are unfit to walk these hallowed passageways.
And you are drunk. Okay, I do think that with my current set of boons, there's a pretty significant chance that I'll lose one of my lives on this battle. But we'll see. Also, my strategy here mostly tends to be that I first want to take down Theseus, because Theseus has the annoying summoning powers. You know, he can summon like all these extra things from other gods. So that's why he tends to be my focus. Oh, is that too many people like that though? I tend to see them separate in a sense. Yeah, no, that's fair. It's like there's quite a few people. For me, it's like there's people that I, whose work I appreciate, who I don't appreciate as people who I can live with. Like, I tend to draw lines at stuff like, well, the obvious stuff like murder, Nazism, that kind of shit, and I'm like, yeah, okay, no. But there is some people on the right wing Republican side who might make art that I do like. But then I'll probably be the kind of person that's like, I like your art, I just think you're an idiot. They'll hear that from me, but that's all early. Oh no! Oh no! 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 No dying! No dying! No dying! Oh, there we go. Good. Yeah, those happen. Anyway, enough about that. Let me finish off this guy. Yes! I got him.
That's all for today's show.
Woo! There we go. Got the ambrosia. Got my fan here. Are you gonna say anything?
Hope you enjoyed the show, my good shade.
Yee! Like the little smile above his head. I love that part.
Guess I'll be going then.
Here we go. Then we move upward.
The worst is yet to come, boy.
Oh no. It's like I read that in Dutch for a second and I was like, is he gonna bring weenies?
I can do this again.
Like, the worst is yet to come? It's like, my brain should not read that. It's like a Dutch birthday. We're gonna sit around in a circle and eat cheese and borscht. Because the worst is yet to come.
The temple.
Here we go.
Something I can use.
Oh yeah, let's beef some of the levels we have. Drunken Flourish,
my senses.
Divine Strike, yeah, okay, I'll take it. Now, let's go to one of these halls. I mean, I do have a pretty good shield on me, so I hope that I can keep these rats on a distance. That would be nice. Yeah, let's go for this.
Should check this way.
All right.
Hello?
Not too bad. Not too bad at all. Okay. Oh, my shield also starts to make the rounds when I hit one character, it hits multiple characters. That is actually kind of convenient. Here we go. Okay. Not too shabby, not too shabby. Now, the rats I can just kill with my dash strikes. I mean, that's just a matter of dashing through them like this. There we go. But it's mostly the bigger enemies that are going to be annoying. Like these fucks. Oh god, I got poisoned. Yes. Awesome. And I just had that 1 second time frame of actually curing my poison. That was nice. Okay. Of course, boss battle. Well, not really a boss battle, but one of the annoying rooms. Also, if you're looking at the screen right now, you can see that some of the wells, the little green spots on the floor, also emanate green fog at times, which also poisons you. So there's like 5 things you gotta take into account when you're playing these rooms. That's your enemies, that's the traps, and it's the poison being launched into the room and everything. They made it a pretty good last level, let's put it that way. It's like they're not gonna make you get into that Hades battle easily. And I have had runs in which I legitimately got murdered here in a room like this. Like, I would lose all my lives and then I would have to fight Hades with nothing. Because, well, these guys poisoned me and I was stuck in a corner and not able to get out of it. It's just really unfair. But at the same time, that's how the game works. Divine Dash. Here we go. Okay, we're gonna go up here. And then it's time for evil in your ear.
Here's the thing.
We're gonna go. What is this? Poseidon. I was kind of hoping I could get Poseidon's call, because that is the one move that I've been missing out on. Yeah. Let's see. Okay, we got these guys. Please let this be the Satyr Sack. I really don't want to fight more. Yes!
Hey, a Satyr Sack already.
I am lucky as fuck!
Your victory is most certainly at hand now that I'm here, nephew.
Okay, can I... Yes, Poseidon's aid. That is the one I wanted. Because Poseidon's aid is ridiculously OP if you press the R2 button in battle. Then you can surf with Poseidon and it deals a lot of damage. So I think I might be able to beat Hades like this. That is... Here we go, let's go beat Hades.
After deliberating briefly, Cerberus concludes that yes, he shall accept the sack.
He accepts the sack. Oh, no. Okay, we're not going there. We're not doing this. I'm stronger than this. No, I'm not. I'm very much not. But okay. Let's see.
Crisp, cold air.
Is this going to be the final round? Come on.
What is it going to take for you to understand that your place is in the house?
And throw a bunch of shields so I can get him, Drunnel.
Darkness.
Okay.
How reckless. Why do you wish to die repeatedly like this?
Well, you're the one doing the dying right now, my dude. Or at least that's the whole idea, is that you're the one doing the dying.
Darkness.
I am doing a lot better than I thought I would. Considering that I'm not using my standard boons and everything, it's, I seem to be murdering him pretty well. Yeah? And indeed, the Divine Dash is helping me because I'm basically reflecting everything that is being thrown at me right now. That was a good choice.
Decided, no problem whatsoever.
Okay, let's surf the fuck out of this dude. Got him! Okay, that's level one. Now for level two. We're not finished. Here we go, guys. Let's go! Yeah, now I'm losing lives, obviously.
Hungry for more, I see. Now this.
Oh. Okay, gotta concentrate on this, but we're getting there. Like, he is hurting me quite bad, but I'm also able to do certain things like these calls.
Poseidon ought not meddle in others' affairs.
But he is. He's meddling like a pro. Not having a fun day. I think it's my father. Wait, no. Oh shit. Okay. Yeah, we are fighting the final boss. I'm noticing it.
Blasted little dick out of me.
I got him! Ladies and gentlemen, I cleared two rounds
last you, boy.
In one stream.
You think you are superior?
That's pretty good, I would say.
You are off. You
shall not,
not
pause. He did a Gandalf.
Did it.
You did it.
Made short work that time.
Ladies and gentlemen, I think this will be a good moment to stop the stream right here. Two streams, two runs, two Hades runs in one stream. And I think that that is a beautiful conclusion to close this off on. So, thank you for watching me bumble through my first gaming stream right here. TDW versus Hades. As far as I'm concerned, I really, really liked it. I learned a lot regarding the technical side and things I want to upgrade and, you know, improve on. Because I'm noticing certain elements like this camera, for example, working pretty well, but also with the capture card, I want to see if I can improve certain things, you know. There's a lot that I want to work on. And thank you for your feedback, and thank you for being here tonight. I'm not sure when I'm going to be game streaming again, but it will happen whenever it happens. And I hope you guys had fun, first and foremost. And I hope to see you all this coming Tuesday, because then we're going to write a new mini song. Yes! It's going to be great. I'm looking forward to that. So, from me to you, and from Little Noodles right here, who has been diligently watching me play Hades all night, I hope you will have a good night, and I will see you all again another time, and see you next Tuesday. All right. Later, guys. I don't have an ending screen, so you're just going to see the intro screen again. You know what? No, we're going to do it differently. I'm going to end this with a message from our sponsor. Because we had a sponsor tonight, and you already know it, but you're going to see it again. Enjoy, stay safe, talk to you later.
Streamwalking will be right back after this message from our sponsor.
In a world that is desperate for salvation, one person picks up their phone and starts swiping for a limited amount of time until they have to wait again so they can do it again tomorrow. This is Bread Darkened Myths, a completely real online MMORPG that you can play on every device imaginable. It's the most popular mobile game since Tuesday, and not at all meant to take more money from your pocket than you're actually aware of. Sign up for the beta version today and get 5 million gold in Acquisitions, which you can use to fight against the Flapdilip. Bread Darkened Myths. Do you have what it takes?
And now back to Streamwalking.